JoshCast 300. JoshCast 300. I'm the guy who runs it. I edit it, I cut it. This is your favorite podcast show that you don't listen to. Out of all the other shows in Philly comedy, this is the first podcast show since 2009. I was doing this so y'all can fucking blow. Now your comics want your dumb podcast on Apple, but I was here first so y'all can have a fucking Snapple. You need to chill the fuck out and show some damn respect before I snap on you and I snap your fucking neck. Sober commentary with drunk people. I talk to drunk people at night and I show you the evil and public freakouts where people speak out. I do my commentary on that and y'all can't reach out. And I got open mic coverage, you wouldn't believe. I drop names and purge bridges so shocked you can barely breathe.
JoshCast 300. I'm the guy who runs it. This comedy scene gets punished. I edit it and I cut it. This is your favorite podcast show that you don't listen to. Out of all the other shows,
episodes, yeah, I'ma do a couple hundred more. Your girlfriend, she's a cock loving little whore. Behind your back, she loves to blow it. You tasting guys come, you don't even know it. Cause you's a bore, I did it. Back on stage where I'm kidding. Y'all not ribbing. Minutes 300, so I'm committed. And you hacks just give up. And I'm gonna make you spit up. Do a give up. And I'ma throw fuck you so you hiccup. So get up. And I'm gonna live it up. And I'ma say what I want. Nobody can stop me, cause to me, everybody's a fucking cunt. So many losers out there steal my fucking jokes. It's obvious if you took a closer note at all the shit I wrote. So go smoke.
JoshCast 300. I'm the guy who runs it. This comedy scene gets punished. I edit it and I cut it. This is your favorite podcast show that you don't listen to out of all the other shows.
Welcome to the JoshCast 300th episode. Yeah, we did it. This is the first but yet worst comedy podcast in Philadelphia. This is your favorite podcast show that you don't listen to. That's right, the first podcast, as I said before, many episodes, I was bringing my microphone and my tape recorder, my tape cassette recorder, that's how long ago this was, to Helium Comedy Club and Northeast Comedy Cabaret, and, you know, doing interviews, you know, doing segments. And listen, I shouldn't have stopped, but I got bitter over the years. And on this episode, I can't promise you that it's going to be good. I can't promise you that I'm going to get stuff. But tomorrow night, it's Tuesday, March 20th. As you know, there's a snowstorm. Tomorrow night, there may not be a Northeast Comedy Cabaret open mic. I'm trying to get as many comedians on as I can on this program to say a few things, whether they know the show or not. Also, I was thinking about doing some new live prank phone calls, maybe a new song for the show, and having some guests on. Listen, it's pretty much going to be a regular episode. I'm trying to make this look like it's special. I just put up on YouTube the JoshCast 299 Live with Bill and Will, the podcast we did at the Northeast Cabaret. And once again, we'll see how it goes. If it's, you know, once again, if it's not a good episode, well, as I said before, sadly, I've been doing this podcast for a long time. I've not been able to build a fan base. And listen, it's hard, man. You know, I'm trying to do the kind of comedy that I like, and fortunately, in this political correctness day and age, it's getting harder and harder to, well, it's not harder to do it, but it's harder for people to want to connect with that. But anyways, I know I say anyways a lot. I'm going to do some topical news right now. And once again, tomorrow, if there is an open mic, whoever's there, maybe get them on the show. Maybe call, make some calls. See what's going on. If no one wants to do the show, well, then it would just be a regular episode. Fuck it, because I'm not going to kiss any butts, as people want you to do. Okay, the JoshCast 300 is sponsored by analleakage.org. May your butthole shine bright like a diamond. It's one of the only sponsors I have. And, yeah, thank you guys for supporting the show. Two Stoneman students arrested for taking knives to school. Ooh. Now, I imagine a lot of people carry pocket knives and stuff. But with these, like, Mashuso knives, you know? Deputy at Parkland School suspended for a nap. Yeah, well, you should be. You're supposed to be fucking, watching things. What are you doing? He had to be black. No, I'm kidding. We don't know the race. Carrie slams Zuckerberg with new artwork. People are shaming Selena Gomez. Oh, why? I thought a lot of people liked that fat baby meat. You know, that fucking... Brett Favre responds to $16 million lawsuit over a failed company. Yeah, some people hate Brett Favre. I think Jim Florentine hates him. But hey, we'll get him on the show for the JoshCast 300. He's a nice guy. I heard do it. Nah, I would never bother him. Yeah, I should, though. New exploding booby trap Parcells cause alarm. The FBI is on the case. Gwyneth Paltrow says Weinstein had an incredible gift. He would invite you up to his room and he would show you his cock. A Fluenza Texan who killed four while driving drunk to be freed. Well, you know, he did his time. What are you going to do? Some Rockets NBA player cited for public intoxication. Well, he's an NBA player. He's drunk in public. What are you going to do? Gingerbread treehouse full of child porn found. Man charged. That's sick. It wasn't sick that he was doing child porn. It was sick that he was doing it in a treehouse. See what I'm saying? Jokes like that, folks, will not get me anywhere. Here's the JoshCast 500. Okay. Family makes gruesome find while searching for dog. Oh, it had found cocaine in its butt. So everything's about Trump. Trump this. Trump and Putin. They're still talking about, of course, the fucking Stormy Daniels and another porn star has come out to sue Trump. Yep. So everyone's just trying to take our president down. He's still our president. If you say he's not, he's our president, folks. If he fails, we fail. I did not vote for anybody. There's a rare dime worth $2 million. Well, folks, start looking at your dimes. And where do you claim that, by the way? You can't just take it to like a deli and go, yeah, I want my $2 million. You know, they're just going to hang up on you. And there's not a lot of news going on. Great way to start the podcast. You know, but once again, folks, I have no clue what's going to happen. As I said before, I might have to download some new beats, yo. I'm going to try to write a new song for the show. And while I do that, once again, if there is an open mic at Cabaret or any coverage, you're going to hear it on this show. This Saturday night, I'm going to try to get people on the show. I'm going to try to just walk up to random people and go, hey, what do you think of the JoshCast? Now, I'm going to be very nervous to do this because I don't approach people anymore. But like I said, most likely this is going to be a regular episode, or I might actually wait another week to see if I can get stuff next week as well, and then put it together. Once again, I'm trying to make this episode special, even though it really isn't. But once again, we will go from there. So this is the JoshCast 300. You know, some people say quality over quantity. I say fuck you, I was here first. This is JoshCast. Keep listening to find out what happens next. All right, I'm about to call Bill Miller for a JoshCast 300 segment. Not doing True Life, not Doritos. I guess that's over. Who knows? Who cares for right now? Because this is JoshCast, so let's give him a ring-a-ding-ding on my ding-a-ling. See if he picks up. Can you hear me now?
Oh, I can hear you now.
Oh, great. That's wonderful. I'm glad. Well, we're doing a JoshCast 300 segment. too lazy to do
this. Congratulations.
Well, thank you.
You know, a lot of podcasts make it up to 300.
So you true. I looked at hundreds of podcast pages, and most people are pussies. They get to a few episodes. Some of them actually got some feedback on their show, and then some people, whatever reason, they just hang it all up.
Not you.
No, not me. For some reason, I'm one of those people that I should give up on certain things, but I just keep on going. That's right.
Well,
now speaking of that, I'm not sure if the True Life Not Doritos is still going on.
That's my favorite.
Yeah, that's a weird thing. So what happened was last Wednesday night, B-Lion, he texted me and said, "Hey, tomorrow you want to do the show online?" But see, it was a miscommunication. I thought we could do the show in person because I already asked you and Will Fitz and the bartender about the live show. So I said, "Well, I already told the guys they were in," and he said that, "Hey, listen, he got upset, whatever." And we did the JoshCast instead. Did you watch the JoshCast 299, the one we did in person?
I did.
How did you think it turned out?
Fantastic editing.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I try to edit people's requests, certain things they want out.
Well, you're the best, because I can't just go off there saying the N-word.
I mean, I was hoping you would, but I mean, well...
I did, but I took it back immediately.
Yeah, well, like I said, I mean, it happens. I mean, it's fun. It's something about me. When people, I'm just such a free guy. When people get around me, they become free, and that's usually bad for them.
Yeah.
I'm just a free
bird. Too much freedom.
Yeah, so anyway, B-Lion sent me a text message Sunday night. Let me read it to you, and... This is the text message he sent me. It's if he starts out by saying if we are going to do a show together, I'm going to need you to not get so defensive and angry all the time. Is that possible? ? Now, apparently he's never heard me argue with my parents, because when I'm angry, I yell, like the way I scream at my parents. I'm like, "Fuck you!" Like,
why'd you bring me into this world?
Yeah.
What,
shit like
why are you
that.
Letting me live here?
Shit, yeah. That's shit like that. So, that's me being angry. I've never yelled at this guy once. I think I've known him for like 6 years or 7 years. I never yelled at him once. So, I'm not sure if he, you know, talks about it with his girlfriend and this is what she puts in his head, or it's him. But, anyways, I do like doing the True Life Not Doritos, but this is the second week in a row we haven't done a show, and, if we don't do a show by Monday, I guess that's it.
Aw.
Yeah, but, you know, listen, we can always do a show, you, me, and we got to find some other... We got to find another white guy who plays the straight man, which is hard to do, but we'll find somebody.
Well, you know what I think it is? I think he just doesn't like criticism.
Yeah, totally.
And we're critical folks.
Well, I'm critical, but see, the thing is, when I give him feedback on something, it's not to, like you said, it's not to bully the guy or hurt the guy. Like sometimes he'll take a few days to text back, or he'll take a few days to put the clips up, so I just want to know, "Hey, man, what's going on?" And I don't think that's a bad thing. I'm not saying, "Hey, you're a piece of shit," or "Hey, you're fucking..."
No.
I could say that stuff, but I don't. And, why the defensive? How is that defensive? And, I don't know, man, but this guy...
I get a lot of this at work. People that don't know me think I'm 100% sarcastic all the time.
Yeah.
And I think that's just a comic thing. Like, you're just a ball buster by nature.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like I said, I never yelled at this guy, but I mean, I did say, "Look, I'll do the podcast another way," but it's like, listen, I mean, I never gave up on the show. And I was willing to do a show Monday, by the way. So Monday, I completely ignored his text message. I wrote him Monday like it never happened. I said, "So, 8:15, you want to test?" That means, you know, test the audio for the show. And he goes, "Okay."
Mm-hmm.
And then he canceled the show, which is fine.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't spoke to him since. So, True Life Not Doritos, I mean, we started this whole thing, all these topics and all this work, and I guess it's possibly coming to an end, but I guess I can still do the. All those shows are pretty much my ideas, so I guess I'll just, you know, just keep doing them and leave them. He can leave them on iTunes, or he can take them down, and I'll just keep putting them up on the YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
He would not ruin.
I like the YouTube.
He would not ruin the legacy. I mean, I wish we had some callers, man, but fortunately, we're not there yet, man. We're not there.
Mm. Would you consider putting your, like, phone number in public places?
Well, I have. I mean, because yeah. I post this on Craigslist, and if you look at one of the sample, every sample video has my two Google Voice numbers on there.
Mm.
So people just don't want to call in, which is mind-boggling. Come on. You know, that's what I say. But, hey, listen, you know, this is supposed to be a special occasion here. This is a 300th episode. No podcast in this city, as pompous as it sounds, is doing a 300th episode. Some people say quality. What is it?
Quality over quantity.
Yeah. So I'm the opposite.
Quantity over quality.
Yeah, I'm the opposite.
We got lots of crap.
Yeah. I tell people, like, I do an hour. Our show myself every week. They're like, "Was it good?" I go, "No, but that's not the point. That's not the point.
Yeah.
It's not supposed to be good, but isn't anybody impressed that I'm doing over an hour of material by myself?"
Well,
apparently not.
That's my thing. When I don't have anything to say, I say,
"Well,"
or I go, "Goodness gracious."
I never heard you say that once, ever.
You just might not pay attention to me.
Oh,
because I say it every time I'm on stage.
Oh, on stage, but I never heard. I'm talking on the show. I've never heard you say.
Oh, yeah, I know exactly what I'm trying to say on the show.
Mm-hmm.
Well.
Yeah.
I'm
going live right now.
I got some
YouTube
stickers.
Oh, you made
some stickers?
You made some True Life Not Doritos stickers? Cool, man.
No, I received some stickers.
All right.
Remember you used to go to the doctor, and after your doctor appointment, when you're a little kid, they gave you a sticker or a lollipop?
Yep.
Mm. That was the days.
Yeah, so what are these stickers? Are the stickers just advertisements for their business?
Pretty much. I got these stickers in the mail. Sometimes you pay like $5 and they give you 100 stickers.
Uh-huh.
A bunch of random stickers.
I see.
But today I got some stickers. They say, Andre the Giant has a posse, but there's a worm all over his face.
Oh, man.
Now, I like to get stickers. I like to put them in public places.
So, like, do you put them on, like, bathroom stalls and such?
I like to put them on the back of signs. Like a stop sign, not on the red part.
Mm-hmm.
On the back.
Oh.
And I'd be like, oh, I must be around here, because that's one of my stickers.
It's pretty badass.
I think so. I'm making the town a little bit more punk rock.
Mm-hmm. I tested this before I called you. I called a black prostitute on Backpage.
Well, she just happens to be a prostitute.
Well, you know, working lady, whatever you want to call her these days. And,
yeah. She doesn't have to be black.
Well,
She decided to be black today for this profession.
She has a narrow, sharp, narrow buttocks. Very nice. Yeah. Now, so I'm doing this podcast, So Many Black Girls. So I was thinking you could be a guest on it. We can do a segment right now, and I can just chop it up and put it in there.
Well, have her call.
Well, no, not with her. I mean, just with you.
Oh, what, I call her?
No, there's nothing to do with her. I'm talking about just you and me, and then I put it on the show.
Oh, of course.
All right, so we did that.
Now, hey, what's a pencil with no tip?
An Asian guy's dick or something?
No, it's pointless.
Pointless.
Optical joke.
Oh, did you get that off? What's it called? A Laffy Taffy?
No, I got it off of a Popeyes.
Okay. Oh, yeah, a popsicle joke, right?
You know.
Now, what do you want to say about the JoshCast 300? Do you have anything? It doesn't have to be nice, by the way.
I just did a celebratory cough lock. I just had to take a rip for the 300th episode.
There you go. 300 hits for 300 episodes.
That's right. I got this from the Mad Flavors. I don't know. You know Joey Diaz?
Yes.
He
I don't know him personally.
He fucking gets high every fucking episode of his podcast.
Nice.
And it's just like, I don't know. I want to hang out with Joey Diaz.
Yeah, man. Pretty sure you can make that happen.
When I listen to him, he's right. His stage name is Uncle Joey. And he's right because he feels like America's uncle.
Yep. Everyone's mobbed, coke dealing uncle.
Oh my God, that's so funny.
Now, do you have anything to say about the JoshCast? It doesn't have to be nice. It could be
I'm sorry.
A roast. Could be a anything. So we're here to celebrate.
I don't know. I met you about a year ago.
Yeah.
And you were doing this podcast right out of your pocket.
That's right.
I was like, well, this guy is just making a podcast out of his pocket.
A pocket cast.
And I've been on podcasts before, but it was always an operation. Like, I had to go somewhere, sit down, and then they would, like, you know, maybe they'll get me high. And I'm like, I'm too high. But this is easy. This is, like, right after a show or on the phone where I can be at home. Or we can meet up at the comedy club. It's a fucking great setup. And you should be very proud of what you're doing.
Yes, I am. And he's right about that. The JoshCast, it's a show you can take anywhere. It's a show that you don't have to drive into the middle of Pennsylvania like some other shows. And, you know, you set up all these mixers and microphones and have your brain all baked by the end of it with all this audio. You can just hang out. Just talking to a phone or talking to a little voice recorder, a little penis clip microphone thing, and you will be on a global show. So I've been trying
to
tell
you. And
you
know what I really like? My favorite segment is when you spill out onto Old City after the bars let out.
Yep.
I do that all the time. What I mean by that is that I like to come up to people that are complete strangers and just start talking to them.
Yep.
Like people in line at the deli or people in line in general. I love a captivated audience.
Yeah, well, this Saturday I'm going to try to get out of my comfort zone to actually talk to people. I used to do that, and then I just started becoming angry and bitter, so now I just... I'm like a little fucking, just angry guy on my phone, just talking about people and stuff. But this Saturday, I'm going to try my best to actually walk up to people and say, so what do you think about the JoshCast 300, huh? 300 episodes, and have them all look at me. And I might get into a fight. Who knows? Someone might punch me in my nose. Could happen. You know, people are very angry. You know, I look like a terrorist, rapist type guy running up with a phone. Who knows? But I'm going to try my best to get out of my comfort and get some coverage for the show. Actually, actual people on the show for the big 300. It's going to be hard. But I want to do it.
You know what you should do?
Yeah.
You should. You do?
No. I mean, yeah, I'm listening.
You should go to like a hippie festival, like a fish concert, and just like walk around the parking lot. Because those are the kind of concerts where people just like hang out in the parking lot because they're on too much drugs to figure out how to get inside a concert.
Yeah, I should go to a festival or something. I never even looked those things up, man. I never even think to even look for a concert. I've never been to a concert before my whole life. Never even thought to even look one. I got invited to a concert with Goat, but he didn't tell me who was playing, and I didn't want to go because I didn't know who was playing.
Well, that's okay.
I should have went, but I was like, well, who's playing?
Yeah.
He wanted to get back to me, so I was like, eh, fuck it.
You need to get, like, weird life experience.
Yeah. You know, who knows? Someone might slip me some ecstasy or something, you know?
Well, I mean, you don't have to do that. You heard Ryan last week. He said he dropped ecstasy and it was cut with baby laxative. So everyone who took the ecstasy was, like, pooping every 14 minutes.
Yep.
Yeah, don't take ecstasy. Don't take drugs from strangers. Get drugs from your friends who bought them from strangers.
Yeah, that's more. I trust that more than just strangers.
It's a little buffer. Because you can't blame a stranger, but you could blame Doug.
You mean Doug from The Hangover?
No, I mean your buddy Doug who gave you that weird acid that wasn't acid.
Yep.
I'm just being vague when I say Doug.
Yes.
I should say like Matt or Mike.
You're just
everyone knows a Matt or a Mike.
You're just speculating. You're not actual. I'm not actually saying someone's name.
Well, I'm just calling out my buddy Doug who fucking sold me acid that wasn't acid.
Yep.
And you know what happened with that?
What happened?
This happened like 8 years ago. The statute of limitations are fine. I bought some acid off of this guy, a friend of mine, and he's like, here's the acid. I'm like, cool, here's the money. And I take it home and I put a little bit of it in my mouth, and I noticed that I could taste it and it was bitter, so I spit it out. And I went over to my buddy's house and I said, hey, man, this is not LSD. And he's like, really? I'm like, yep, it's not. And he's like, how do you know? I'm like, because I taste it and you're not supposed to. So, kids, if you ever, like, put acid in your mouth and you can taste it, spit it out immediately. Because you don't know what it is.
And the acid might actually melt you. Like a mortal, like that,
yeah,
Baraka, Mortal Kombat.
That's right.
Such a great game.
But, fucking... So guess what happened?
What happened?
He got in his Jeep, and he drove on down. And he doesn't really drive a Jeep. But I just say that because it's a fun thing to say. He drove down to where he got it. And he was like, hey, man, fuck you. This isn't what I said. This isn't what you said it was. And he pulled out a knife, and he cut this guy's hand open.
Whoa.
Yeah. Well, he pulled out a knife, and he said, this isn't acid. This isn't LSD. This is something weird. And the guy was like, whoa, no. And he grabbed the knife. Like, to keep him from getting stabbed, he just grabbed the knife. And he cut his hand open real bad. And it bled. And then everyone just left.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's a cool story, man. Not for the guy that got his hand cut, but
in no, general. Fuck that guy. He was selling stuff that wasn't stuff.
Yeah.
It was other stuff.
Yeah, man. That sounds pretty interesting. That's a good drug story. I'm not into drugs,
thanks.
But If I was. Well,
you're into stories.
I'm into stories. Any kind of stories. Poop stories. Any kind of stories.
Here's a story for you.
All right.
One day, I was at one of those festivals. And it was a 3-day festival. It was the first day. It was the first time I ever smoked meth.
Yep.
And I'm smoking meth for like 2 days. And on like the third day, I was like, that's it. I'm not smoking any more meth. I'm still awake. And I'm drinking beers like crazy. And I'm not getting drunk. I'm just up on this stuff. So I'm like, fuck this. I'm going to sell all my beers. Because when you're smoking meth, you got all this ambition. You know, you got all these things that you could do, and your mind's always twisted. And so you're just trying to like, well, I'll just make money. So I'm selling all these beers that I certainly don't want to drink anymore. And I'm up all day in the sun, and I'm up all night for like 3 days. And it's the third night, and I've got like a few more beers left, and I'm just selling these beers. And I come across this guy outside of a RV. Mm-hmm. And I'm talking to this guy, and he's telling me that he's like, oh, yeah, I'm in this band. We're a Grateful Dead cover band. We're called the Grateful Bread. This, that, and the other thing. This is our tour van. Here, come on in. And I come in, and it's, like, so nice. Like, it has air conditioning. There's power. And I'm just like, oh, this is great. And he's like, oh, we have a couch. And I sit down on the couch. And it's so nice. And I just, like, lay down, and someone put a blanket over me. And let's fast forward, because I finally fell asleep. And then I woke up, and I noticed the van's moving.
You're telling us, like, a horror story.
Well, let me tell you, it was scary. And I was woken up. Because people are waking me up. Mm. And I feel that I'm in a moving vehicle. And I look over, and there's these guys, and they're like, hey, man, who are you? I'm like, I'm Bill Miller. Who are you? Where are we? And he's like, we're on the way to Georgia. We're on 95 going all the way south. I'm like, well, where are we now? Because I'm not, what? And he's like, we're in South Carolina. We're North Carolina. We're on the border of Maryland.
Damn.
We're almost, yeah, they just passed the border of Maryland. So I'm like, well, you're taking me back. Why did you take me? And he's like, okay, well, here's the thing. We thought you were Steve, and Steve just woke up in the back. I'm like, you thought, and I look over, and Steve is like my height and my weight, and he had brown hair, and I was under a blanket. And I'm like, well, why did you think I was Steve? It's like, we thought you were Steve, and we didn't think Steve was in the way back. Like, well, this is really dumb. You guys are dumb. And it's like, you fell asleep on my bus. I'm like, why did you let a stranger fall asleep on your bus? And I was like, I know this guy. This guy brought me on my bus. Why didn't this guy take me off the bus when you left? And he's like, I don't know. I was asleep too. So I'm like, well, what's going to happen? Well, what we could do is we could drop you off. Huh. I'm like, what the fuck? I feel my pockets. I have my wallet. And I have my cell phone. Well, my cell phone's been dead. It's been dead for like 2 days. Especially when you smoke meth and you want to play with it. But so I'm like, okay, well, can anyone charge my phone? And they're like, yeah, we can charge your phone if you got one of these plugs. No, I don't have one of those plugs. All right, so I'm fucked. I'm like, where are you gonna drop me off? Well, they'll turn around and they'll get northbound on 95, and they'll stop off at like a bus stop or like, you know, those parking rides.
Mm-hmm.
They drop me off in a parking ride.
No. Oh.
And I'm like, okay, well, I have. Oh, here's the best part. I'm wearing fucked up clothing. I was in a festival, right?
Yeah.
So I'm wearing like cool pants. Like these pants are like patchwork, hippy dippy looking pants. And that's, you know, okay. It's pants. But the shirt. I was wearing a shirt and it's like a dude camping. And he's being abducted by aliens, you know, by one of those beams.
Mm-hmm.
Except it's not a spaceship. It's a naked lady. And you could see her vagina and you could see her tits. And she's squatting over, abducting a guy.
Whoa.
Like, she's like bigger than mountains. And her vagina has a beam. But here's the thing. I'm like, it's bleached. I can't even turn it inside out. You could see the pattern either way. So I'm like, guys, look at the way I'm dressed. You're going to have to give me a shirt. And they said, all right, no problem. And they gave me one of their t-shirts. It was like a fucking shirt. So then they bring me on to the fucking bus stop or whatever. And I'm like, guys, you got any change? You got any money? Cause I don't have any money. I had a couple of dollars and I had my wallet. So I wasn't fucked, but I was like, give me like all your loose change so I can get a coffee. And they're like, all right. So they gave me like a handful of loose change. And I took that loose change and I got myself a machine candy bar and donuts. And now I had to assess the situation. No one knows where I am. My car is in Pennsylvania, but even better, it's in a parking lot at a concert. So I have to get back to my car before they take it away. No one knows where I am. My parents don't know. No one knows. I'm an adult. It didn't feel like it, but I was. So I start going up to people in the parking lot and family people are like, all right, kids, get in the car. This guy's walking up to me. You know, I'm like, I'm just looking for a ride. Well, I'm not going to give you one. All right. I'm walking around and I'm asking people, I'm wearing a tie-dye t-shirt. I'm like, can I get a ride? I just want to go northbound as far as I can go. And eventually this one guy let me on and he's like, tell me your story. I tell him everything. And he's like, let me see your shirt. And I show him my shirt. He's like, yeah. And I told him, like, I have, like, a pounding headache. And he's like, oh, yeah, why? I was like, oh, never mind. Maybe I won't tell you I'm smoking meth. But it turns out this guy was like a deadhead guy, and he was going north to like New York. And I told him, like, dude, you can just drop me off at the Tendell exit on I-95. And he was like, I'm totally going to do that. All I had to do was fucking pay for his full tank of gas. So eventually I got back to the Pendell exit, and he dropped me off at the Morrisville, where the concert was. And they were packing up. Everyone was packing up to leave. And they were just about to, like, they were looking in the woods for a dead body, because there was one car that no one's attending, and they almost towed it away. And they're like, oh, this is your car? I'm like, yeah, the Grateful Bread took me away. And they're like, oh, wow. Well, see you later. And that's my really long, dumbass story.
Well, after listening, after listening to that, I don't think I want to go to concerts.
All right. That was a very unique experience.
No, it was, but I'm saying that that's what scares me. I'm afraid I'm going to pass out, and then I'm going to end up on a chicken truck or something.
No, you can pass out where I'm at. I won't pass out next time.
I'm going to call. Let's call Goat. Let's see if he picks. Let me know if you can hear the ringing. Let's see if it rings, and you can
ask Goat if he ever
He goes to concerts all the time, so this guy's had to do some hardcore drugs. He's got to be a big now, drug.
I never smoked meth since.
Oh, well, I'm happy for you. That's a terrible drug.
I mean, it's perceived as terrible. I'm sure there's some people that are really good at it.
All right, let's see. Calling. Can you hear that?
I don't hear any ring.
All right. And, wait, meter.
Oh, I hear that.
Hello?
Hey, you're on the JoshCast 300.
Is there anybody out there?
Goat! I just hung up on him.
Yeah, he's having the same issue.
Alright, let me try him one more time, because I didn't have to see. That's the thing, I'm using this dumb program, and you gotta fucking have the settings just like everything else. This is gay, you know. Audio is gay, everybody. That's what I'm here to say. Hey, audio is gay. Hey.
So, if I can imagine, whenever I never see a person, but I could hear their voice, and I heard about them a lot, I paint this picture in my mind of who they are. Like an archetypal figure.
Yeah.
Yo.
Can you hear me?
Yo, who's this?
You're on the JoshCast 300.
No way.
Yeah, man. This is the 300th episode.
Why do you sound Cuban?
I don't know. I'm trying to act excited, even though nobody cares. You're on with Bill Miller.
Bill Miller? E. Bill Miller? Yeah.
Yep. Yep.
William Miller.
Tell him my social security number. He knows it.
Yeah, he says...
Does he have a credit card number I can have?
Can you hear him, Goat?
No. He said something about social security?
Bill, yeah.
Yeah, he heard me.
I thought I might have.
Yeah, say partially. Something, Bill. Talk to him.
Hey, go.
What's up, Bill?
What was the last concert you went to?
What was the last concert?
Yeah.
I just saw MGMT on Monday night.
How is the management?
that what that stands for?
Yeah.
I thought it was a bank.
You know, they used to be called the management, and then they had to change their name for some legal purposes. Little fun fact for you guys.
That's pretty cool. I've seen them open up for Of Montreal.
Really? Of Montreal's coming also.
Oh, really?
Of Monty. Why, you want to go with me?
Yeah, totally.
You with me, my friend Brandon?
That'd be a great time.
All right. Let's get in touch. You should get in touch with me.
All right, Josh, can you hook that up?
Yeah, I can hook that up, but right now we're doing a big JoshCast 300. Now, Goat's been on.
Oh, Josh, you're still here.
Unfortunately. Now, you've been on many episodes by force. You know, we all know I'm a rapey type guy. I rape people to do podcasts and such, and, you know, many Jack and Rod segments we've done.
Many.
We haven't done one. We're supposed to do one. Remember the Jack and Rod improv? Now, that was probably our best.
What, but we went to the massage parlor?
Yeah.
That was funny.
Those were good times. That was a good... A good time, I should say.
Good times.
Yeah, we're supposed to do always one. And, but then it got, you know, you had to go to a concert. And I selfishly switched my night because I knew the Hollywood Tavern was going to suck. And I didn't want to go there, so I did Jersey's. Well, I went advanced anyways.
I understand.
Now, how was your night?
I had the worst set ever.
What'd you do?
I forgot, literally, four, like, jokes. Because I was just getting over being sick. I still am. And I, like, totally fucked up joke. Like, didn't say, I totally said the wrong thing. It was hilarious. And every time I'm like, fuck, another one I messed up. I really am still sick. It was very frustrating.
What are you sick of?
I had a viral infection.
Gross.
It's not like venereal.
A viral infection of the throat?
I couldn't help. Excuse me?
Was it of the throat, the chest?
Yeah, all of those.
Shit.
This throat, chest. It was bad.
So it was a virus. It wasn't bacterial, so they didn't give you antibiotics.
Wow. Are you a doctor, too?
Well, I'm really sick all the time.
Oh, that's not healthy.
Well, that makes him an expert,
well,
then.
You know, I don't take the flu shot. But I lick doorknobs instead.
See what?
I lick doorknobs.
That's healthy. You know, doorknobs are
you gotta stay up to top.
That's a fact.
Yeah.
Oh my god. So, Goat, we gotta have a segment that's like hipster douchebag segment.
Oh my god, we were surrounded by hipster douchebags at the MGMT concert, as a matter of fact.
That's what I'm saying.
It was unbelievable. Like 15 of them were around us. It was horrible. And they were all tripping on acid.
I'm sorry.
They were tripping and they were so loud. Oh, and they were so tall. What's with these kids today in their height?
I'm looking at the Google image right now. The lead chick looks like she's in the Flintstones. She's got like fire hair, right?
What are you talking about, Montreal?
No, the MGMT.
Oh, the lead singer's a guy. What are you talking about?
Oh, it looks like a woman with a wild hair wig.
Maybe the guy was wearing a wig that show.
But it looks like a woman, though.
No, there's no women in the band.
Oh.
Two main guys. They have two guys who do all the music and write stuff, and then they tour with a band also. So they have, like, I think three other guys in the band besides the two guys who write all the shit.
Now, do you dance, Goat?
Anyway.
Do you do what you do in your car?
Yeah,
like,
I dance. No, I dance? Stand there like the other afraid to enjoy life people.
If I would go to a concert, I would just stand there stiff, and if someone bumped into me, I would go, "Hey, man, what are you doing?"
I could see you doing that.
Like, I'm trying to enjoy the show. Do you have to be a freak? Do you have to bounce around? You can't just enjoy life? What is with you people?
That's the Polish in you, not the Cuban.
That's right.
The Cubans love to dance.
Fuck yeah. Now,
I have these old-fashioned jokes.
You're watching this Trump fucker, Karen McDougal, talk to Anderson Cooper prior to you calling. And I've never hated a beautiful woman so much since I first saw Kellyanne Conway. Come on. She's like super hot. She looks just like Melania. Right?
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? The Karen McDougal Playboy bunny chick. So she's talking all about having sex with Trump.
And you talking about Stormy Daniels?
She's totally into health and fitness, right? It's hot babe. But the first time she slept with Donald Trump. No condom.
That's right. Well, that's different.
She's probably into the kind of health and fitness that you hear about on Facebook and not from, like, a health and fitness person.
Yeah, but health, you know, well, she's a Playboy bunny. She's in great shape. But, I mean, isn't that pretty important, health? Not having sex with someone so you really know them unprotected?
Well, no, man, because that's
a Republican. I hate her. I hate this woman. She's like, he was so sweet and kind to me. I'm like, he wanted to fuck you, you idiot.
Well, that's enough. I mean, a billionaire who does that.
I can't believe a Playboy bunny's stupid. That's all I'm saying.
Really? You ever watch The Girl Next Door?
No. What's that?
It's the Playboy bunny's reality show. The main chick, what's her name, Kendall, she fucks the big black...
Oh, the one who was who was with Hank, the former Eagles wide receiver.
Yeah, she's taking the BBC. Now, Goat, did you think you were going to advance last Thursday?
No. I had no friends.
Oh.
I had a couple friends, and I did really... Besides the fact that I did really horrible, I really had, like, my worst set ever.
Yeah,
I even fucked up my agnostic joke. Yeah.
Now there was three female comics advance.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, the three holes on the show they all got through.
So it had to be the girl with the big butt, the lesbian chick.
Who had a big butt? Else? Was she
the one who advanced?
Does she have glasses?
Semifinals, they advanced?
Yeah. Does she have glasses and like scraggly hair?
Who, the lesbian chick?
No, the chick with the big butt.
Kind of had, like, curly-ish hair.
She yeah, yeah, she did. Yeah.
Like, Arabic or something?
Yeah. And the black chick advanced, and the tall used-to-be lesbian,
oh, really?
Now
that
straight.
Also advanced, the black girl?
Yeah, all three female comics advanced, yep.
Well, they were probably best on that night, to be honest with you.
Did you leave before the votes went in?
I left right after everyone was done performing, before they actually...
That a boy.
I knew I wasn't. I was sticking around to see Andrew Mahan do his Disney songs. As much as I love Andrew, I didn't need to see that Disney routine again.
I want you to suck my cock. I want to show you my vagina. You don't want to hear that again?
You have a better voice than he does.
Thank you. Something. Thank you.
Well... A pleasure.
Well, Goat, say something nice or bad about the JoshCast 300.
Something nice or bad. It's like the old Dick Martin thing.
Hey-o!
I said it. The JoshCast 3000 is the most awesome podcast in the history of podcasts.
It's the only show to have Rod Goat Sperling on.
I've been on many shows, Josh.
Oh, yeah, like that one.
I'm a radio award winner. I've been on Millionaire Matchmaker. Don't forget that.
Matchmaker. Remember that one show I made you do twice?
Millionaire Matchmaker.
That show we did twice, I made you drive all the way down the middle of Pennsylvania, that guy who tries to be like a real radio guy, that asshole.
Oh, your friend who they called you up with a phony prank call threatening to sue you?
Yeah.
Did you think that was real when that was happening, that suit?
Well, I was drunk, so I was at the cabaret doing a podcast.
You did buy it a little.
I did buy it a little because I was drunk and I had two beers, which is enough to get me drunk. So when he called me up, I thought he was serious, but then in the middle of it, I realized it was a shtick because they were laughing in the background.
Because they were laughing at you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I actually listened to that for a few minutes. I was Josh thinks this is serious. Is he playing along?
Did you listen to their line or my show when you heard it?
I don't remember. I didn't listen long. Don't get excited.
Well, I'm going to give you Bill Miller's number so you guys can be concert buddies.
Well, you have my number. You certainly can give him my number and have him text me, and then I'll store it.
And
we'll
yeah.
We'll go to Of Monty together.
You see the chops?
Me, him, Brandon, my kid, and a few of his friends are going.
Well, it sounds like a good old-fashioned white guy party, and I like it.
You can come, Josh.
Nah. Not my
of Montreal fault. is a pretty good first concert.
Of Monty?
Yeah.
They're fun. They got a lot of cool shit going on.
I once took some people there. Times. Like, I used to see him in college. What? Of Montreal? I used to see him a lot in college.
Would you go to Athens?
No, I wouldn't go to Athens. Go. But I used to see him a lot. And I brought all my friends. And one time, my friends invited some other friends. And they're like, yeah, we'll go. All my friends are going, yeah, I'll go. And they show up, and Of Montreal comes on the stage, and the guys go, whoa, this is gay, and they leave.
So they're open-minded friends.
Oh, yeah. They were, I don't know, they're actually Republicans.
Shocking.
Young Republicans.
Oh, my God, the lead singer's wearing a dress. We have to leave.
Yeah, exactly.
That's great.
Well, I'm gonna get used to in touch, but sorry, Bill. Go ahead.
I think the guy came out, and he said he's wearing a wedding dress, and he said,
"Right,
Philadelphia, we're going to get." Oh no, he said. I'm so stoned. He said. Philadelphia, I'm going to make love to you all night long, but first, we need to get married. And then it's like, you know, it was magical, but very gay.
Very good.
But that was awesome. It was awesome.
Yeah, all right, fun. Well, I'm going to get used to a touch. Goat, thanks for... I made you do the show without you knowing, but thanks, man.
Yeah, you're lucky I picked up. I usually don't pick up unknown numbers, Josh.
Actually, you do, because remember when I called you on that Passive Aggressive Hour show? You not only did you pick up, you called the number back.
Well, I had a feeling it was you, didn't you?
To be honest, you thought it was...
My back tension.
You thought it was a chick you banged a long time ago and wanted some more. Be honest. You're such a lover. Rod Goat Sperling, everybody. Thank you, Rod. He's still there. See you, Rod. All right. Well, Bill, I have to wrap this up because I have to take a poop. But thanks for doing
awesome.
The segment. Next Thursday, we might do a True Life Not Doritos, or if not, we'll do a JoshCast at the Cabaret in person, another video show.
That sounds great.
Yeah, so Bill Miller, thank you for being a part of my show, and thanks for always doing the show and True Life Not Doritos. It's always good to have you on. I'm glad that you are part of this universe, you know.
Oh, thank you very much.
All right, Bill Miller, everybody. I'm going to text you Goat's number so you guys can stir up some chaos together.
That's excellent. And Josh, congratulations on your 300th episode.
Thanks, Bill.
Anytime.
JoshCast 300. We're going to keep going. Josh Kess, prank calls, take two.
That's 7-Eleven.
Yeah, man. You want to be on the Josh Kess 300? No? All right. So that guy did not want to be on the JoshCast 300. It was official. He has no time for my games. He's got to make a fucking pizza. A shit fucking pizza to just burn your ass.
Hello?
Yes, is this the 711?
Yeah, 711.
Yeah, do you still want to be on the JoshCast 300?
The 300?
Yeah, the JoshCast 300th episode. I called earlier. I gave you a name for the delivery driver.
I don't have the idea.
Yeah, it's called JoshCast. It's your favorite podcast show that you don't listen to.
But are you talking about the red box?
Yeah.
We don't know what is in the red box and who delivers it. I mean, they are just using the 7-Eleven parking lot only.
Yeah, the JoshCast Corporation uses the red box.
Okay.
Yeah, so you still want to be on it?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I just need a quick question from you. What was your favorite episode from the JoshCast?
I don't have any idea.
Can I speak to a customer?
Customer...
Yeah, I'm calling for the corporate office.
Okay.
I just need to speak to a customer just about the cleanliness of the store and,
Hello?
Yeah, hi, are you a customer?
Yes.
I just wanted to know, is the store clean? Because I can't keep an eye on these guys.
Yes.
Oh, that's very nice. Do you use the red box at all?
Do I use the red box? No, I got enough box. I'm sorry.
Okay, is JoshCast still your favorite podcast?
What is it?
JoshCast.
No, I don't even know what that is.
Okay, you can hand the phone back to him. Thanks. Hello? He hung up. Well, that was a good one. I got a customer on the phone, and she doesn't listen to JoshCast either. We gotta change this. This is not cool. People are not listening to JoshCast. This is your favorite podcast show that you don't listen to. And, yeah. Well, someone's called back. Hello, JoshCast Studios.
Yes, I had a missed call from someone.
Yeah, I just wanted to know what was your She calls me, and then as soon as I said JoshCast Studios, she probably thought about what I said. And she probably hung up. Let's try another number here.
Yes, 7-Eleven, may I help you?
Yes, hi. My name is Joshi, and I'm calling from the corporate office. How are you doing today, sir?
Good.
I just wanted to know, is the red box working okay? Any complaints on the red box?
What kind of red box, bro?
You know the DVD outside? You know the thing that carries all the DVDs?
Mm-hmm, yeah, I know, bro.
Yeah, is it going okay?
Maybe okay, bro.
Well,
I'm not sure.
Is, people, are they still, written out the JoshCast? The JoshCast 300?
Mm-hmm.
That's great. Now, I want to know, when is the last time you cleaned your store?
Oh, actually, now manager not here, okay? We just worker.
I know, but when did you clean the store?
You want to say when we clean the store?
Yes.
Oh, we clean maybe 20 January, 20 December, last December, and also... Last, maybe a few days ago, it's going to be maybe last January, last March something, March 5 to 10.
Yeah, because a customer called me and they made a complaint. They said they stepped in jizz.
Okay, don't worry, boss. So when the manager coming here, I'll tell him, okay?
I don't care about the manager. I need to talk to you.
Yo, so who I'm talking?
This is Joshi, J-O-S. H-I, I am from the corporate office.
Okay.
Listen, I need you to do this for me. You're not in trouble, sir. Please do not get nervous.
I don't know. I don't know, bro. Who is about talking? But I don't know. Something happened here, but I don't know.
Listen. You're not in trouble. Please calm down, sir. I need you to listen to the JoshCast.
Mm-hmm.
JoshCast. It's a podcast. Okay. Your favorite podcast that you don't listen to.
Okay.
That's what you need to do, sir.
Okay.
I'm going to bang your mother in the ass.
Okay.
If you do not listen to JoshCast.
Okay.
All right, sir. I will call back later.
Okay.
Clean up the jizz, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
You know, we work here some shift. Maybe I work here few hour. Another guy coming. So I don't know what happened here.
I understand, sir. I'm not here to get you in trouble. I just want to know. This customer was very upset. They have semen, you know, man sperm all over their new shoes. They were crying. I had to give them 10 free Slurpees. Listen, we got to keep this store clean. You see something clean.
Yeah, I want everything clean, bro. Don't worry. If you come right now, we can check everything clean.
Well, that's what I like to hear.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. Woko.
Yes, I'm calling the breakdown for the JoshCast. Alright, that went okay. The JoshCast, my friend. This 7-Eleven sells gas, that's pretty cool. I don't know why. Nobody listens to JoshCast, you guys gotta start listening. Alright, I'm very hurt by this. You know? Let's see. I'm not good at talking and typing. Multitasking, they call it.
Thank you for calling 7-Eleven. Karen speaking. How may I help you?
Yes, hi. Do you guys still have the JoshCast 300?
The what, hon?
Do you guys still have the JoshCast 300?
I don't know what you're talking about.
It's a gasoline.
No.
I was told that 7-Eleven exclusively sells JoshCast 300.
I haven't seen it.
Oh, so have a lot of people still been using the red box?
Yeah, we don't have it.
Well, what about the red box outside?
No, we don't have a red box outside.
What about the DVD outside?
Nope.
Did you guys clean up the Slurpee mess?
No.
Do people still buy microwave burritos there?
Hey, baby.
I need to know about the microwave burritos. How often do people buy the microwave burritos? Alright, she put me on hold and I thought if I said that she would customers would hear it and she would get in trouble. Someone said I need to get a life. You need to get a life, pal. So what? It's my podcast. I'm trying to get content here.
Hello.
Yes, hi. I wanted to know, do you do audio performances as well?
No.
Okay. I was trying to go for something there, but she said no. She doesn't even know what audio performances is, and she just hung up. And I hung up on her, actually. She doesn't even know what that means. I was going to say, I want to use audio for the JoshCast 300. Let's see. Let me call one more of those girls. Asians, you know, they're fun and all, but they can't speak English that well, which is cool. This white girl's fat as shit. What the fuck is she doing on her? Tired of fucking black guys from the bar? She doesn't even know what that means. Like, you do audio performances? No. You fucking hoe. She's not picking up. Fucking whore. You fucking little whores. You fucking little boys. Wait a minute. Somebody's text messaging me. Yeah, they don't pick up the phone and then they want to text you and go, hey. Hey, daddy, you little whore. Ah, they don't fucking answer their fucking phone. Nobody wants to talk to me. All right, we'll do some more later. All right, let's get to some public freakout commentary. There is no topical news. There probably won't be much topical news this episode. So let's just get straight to the fucking public freakouts. This is from the Online Fails YouTube channel, episode 344. And this is a guy who takes business classes. That's what he says in the video. He is angry because he feels ignored at a Dunkin' Donuts. He's trying to get this man and this woman in trouble, and they both get an attitude with him. And it's kind of humorous, especially at the part where he says, "I take business classes." It's kind of douchey to say that. So let's get to this.
Wait for what, customers? No, no, no. I want to talk to your manager now. You're going to get in trouble, and she's going to get in trouble. Oh, you don't think so? For what? For what? Customer service. You know, every company has to have good customer service. You ain't doing that shit. She's seeing me.
So this guy says, "You're trying to get me to do some illegal ass shit." What was he trying to get you to do? Put crack into donuts? The fuck is he talking about?
Look, bro. Look, she's seeing me 5-10 minutes. She, instead of attending the customer, she goes over there and ignores me. She was over here. Okay, but look, when a client's here, customer comes first. You know that? Customer always comes first. You know that?
You're trying to make me do that, somebody's gonna get me in trouble.
No, customer.
I'm not gonna lose my job.
Call the manager in the morning. She's here, okay?
No.
I'm not gonna argue with you right now or nothing. You see?
And now this bitch comes over, and now she's all smiling and giggling and shit. What's so funny, cunt?
You're gonna get fired too, and you're gonna get fired too. Yeah, okay. You'll see. I'm gonna call corporate Dunkin' Donuts, and I'm gonna call your manager because you two people think I seen how you guys are working. You guys are working shitty because you two there's you know why there's two workers right now. One should always be here. One should always be there.
You're a manager?
You think I don't know how fucking business works? I take business classes. I take business classes.
There it goes. There's the revelation right there. He takes business classes, so he knows how customer service works according to his standard. I gotta get this guy in the Market Yourself podcast.
So do you think
you should already know that we can't give you money like that?
No. I should know that you should know.
Nah.
Yeah.
You should know that you should know.
No.
But you don't.
No.
So you don't know.
No, you guys think you're right, but
no,
watch.
You think you're right.
I am right.
You're not right.
The customer is always right. Actually, half the times they're actually wrong.
Well, we'll see you tomorrow. I'm going to talk to your manager, I'm going to talk to corporate, and if your manager wants to stick with you guys, corporate's going to talk to that manager. Okay?
Okay.
You guys got it?
Are you finished?
Yeah, I'm finished.
Can I continue with my day now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I continue with my day now? There's no customers in a store. Maybe that guy's right. Maybe the service is shitty. Now we're to get to episode 346. There's three clips in this episode. This one in the beginning is pretty entertaining. This is a guy. I'm not sure if this guy's a troll or a genius or both. He sees this woman, rear-end this car or hit this car. And the woman in the car who got hit doesn't seem to mind. But this guy, he gets his camera out and he starts yelling at the woman who hit her and says, "You know, you hit her car." And this woman has a really squeaky, annoying, fucking cartoony voice. She starts yelling at him, and this guy is just, he's like an instigator, but he's funny. Thank God he did this. This is why public freakouts are awesome. So let's get to this.
There's a person in that car, and you hit their car. She's screaming at me. She hit your car while you're in it. You felt it, right? Is there any damage?
What the hell is wrong with me?
You hit her car!
No, I didn't!
I saw you do it! I have it on dash cam!
I don't care!
I have video footage of it with my dash cam! I have video footage of it! You see what's in the car while you hit her!
I didn't hit the car! I didn't feel it! I honestly didn't!
You did!
Okay, I'm sorry!
Now, this is why it gets funny. This woman starts freaking out. This is why this is called public freakouts. Now, on top of that, it seems like the woman in the car doesn't even mind. She seems upset, but this guy, he seems more upset than anybody. This is why this guy is funny. And now this chick's going to start freaking out. This guy is just great, man.
I'm not causing an accident. I'm what stopping you from getting away with committing a crime.
Where am I going? I'm right here. Where have I gone?
Tell me that's not a cartoon voice. I need to get her on the show. I need to get her on a project. I'm telling you.
What do you want to do?
You need to give her your insurance information so she can get that fixed.
You think I don't know how to handle my life?
Look at this. It's cracked. Look what you did.
Go away, you stupid... Before I call the police on you.
Call the police. Then you're the one going to jail. I got video footage of you doing what you did.
You think I
got a dash cam. You see this?
I don't care. Do you think
I saw you back into it.
Or do you think I've run away?
And you cracked it up!
Just give me your insurance information.
Have I run away? I haven't run away.
Give her the insurance information so she can get this fixed when you cracked on her car. Right? You backed into someone's car while she's in it.
Oh my God, would you shut the... Who are you? Get
it. I'll tell you who this guy is. This guy is probably the coolest fucking guy ever. This guy's getting fucking content for people like me. This guy rules. He's a nosy fucker, but I love him.
Get out of here, you creep! You stink like booze!
I'm a good citizen.
Oh my God, you
yes, I have a pen.
I'm not dealing. You need to go away. He's not going to help me about my
I can call the police if I need to. Yeah, I smell like booze.
She's saying he still smells like booze. Maybe the guy was drinking, but he's still cool.
But you're the one who's drunk. You're the one who's drunk.
What did I do? I haven't gone anywhere.
Maybe I should get the police down here.
Please.
I got you on videotape backing into her car.
Okay.
You backed into her car and she was sitting in it when you did it.
Well, now she's not saying anything. Now she's just sitting there. Give her the insurance information.
I bet you she's under the influence of alcohol.
Not excuse of her drinking. All right, so this next clip is very short and sweet. It's a woman. I think she's a Mormon virgin psycho, and she's talking about pimps and hoes. This is only like 30 seconds, but she's wearing like a really... Well, she dresses like a virgin. She looks like Freddy Krueger. That's how she dresses. Let's get to this.
Me?
Wait, hands up! Hands up!
How many people?
Behind them all.
Wait! How many of you guys are out here pimping the hoes?
All right, now this is the last one. This is right after three back-to-back. This is a guy who wants to pay with pennies. And this gas station clerk, this Indian guy, has enough, and he says, fuck you to him. It's pretty entertaining. Let's get to this.
You count it for me.
Dude, that's fine.
You count it. That's one.
That's one. I just did.
I don't know. You count it.
Dude, I'm telling you, that's $1.
You count. How much? You put it? 10 cents. I can't be counting for you, right?
Oh, my God, man.
Come on, you do it.
Dude, are you serious?
You want to buy the thing?
Yeah, I'm telling you, that's $1. I just counted it.
How come it's $1?
Because I just counted it over there in my car.
Yeah, not here.
In my car.
Not in front of me.
Oh, dude, I'm telling you, that's your job. That's your job.
You take your money back, and that's it. You won't save you. Yeah, go out.
I'm not gonna leave.
You gotta leave.
I'm just trying to get a milk.
Yeah,
I don't know. You're making a bit.
You can't.
This is $1.
Yeah, you can't in front of me.
I counted, that's $1.
You counted in there, man. Fuck you.
Oh my God. Fuck
me. This guy just lost his temper and said, fuck you. Now, I'm looking at the change in the picture right now from the video, and he's right. It doesn't look like it's $1. It looks like I see maybe 4 or 5 dimes. It looks like there's 50 cents, and there's not 50 pennies. There's maybe like 20. There's like 70 cents right there. So the guy's like about $2 short, and he's trying to cheat this Indian guy out of the meal. And then the guy just had it and said, fuck you. This guy's cool.
Hey, you counted out in the car. But you can't insult
okay,
me.
Okay, you just insulted me. I never insulted you. I don't know
what no,
you
wanted me to count
know,
your money,
get,
man.
I don't
your money, you
I don't understand. I don't understand how you gotta insult me.
You go outside, right now.
Why, oh. You gonna kick me out because I'm trying to
I'm not kicking you out.
I'm not
but
disrespecting
you. Count this money.
All I'm trying to do is buy my milk, that's
if you,
it.
If you can't do it,
that's what I have.
You go outside then.
Look, it's right here.
Yeah, you go outside.
$3 and this is $1.
Yeah, $4.
This is $1 right
that's
here.
That's not $1, you count in here.
What do you wanna bet?
You count.
I'll bet you a milk. That's $1.
Kill, man.
Can you stop being rude?
No.
You
it's so weird how they didn't bleep out fuck you the first time, now they bleep it out the second time. What was so special about the second time?
Your money
that,
here.
That's $1.
No, I can't
I'm
receive
not insulting
that.
You.
I can't receive this money like
okay,
that.
Okay, I get it, but you can't be treating customers like that.
I know, you're
that's
a customer.
That's not right, man.
I'm sorry.
You want to ring me up?
No.
You in the middle of you, I mean, you can ring me up.
No.
You know.
You guys just give him a milk now?
Because customers like you come here,
me.
You cause problem.
How am I causing problems?
You cost no money.
That's what I just told you. That's
$1.
I personally counted it.
You count in front of me because I'm taking it.
How much I can go?
Come on.
That's $1,
you,
man.
You count it, man.
I'm telling you, that's $1.
You count.
You're being lazy. You're being lazy.
I'm not lazy, okay?
You're being
I'm
lazy.
About to have a free soda in
I'm
a minute.
Not lazy.
You're being lazy.
I'm not lazy.
The guy said, I'm about to have a free soda in a minute. What do you think this is, McDonald's in the 90s, you idiot?
Job,
you are
too.
An asshole.
I'm not an asshole.
Yes.
I'm
that's
simply
why you
bring
money
in.
Like
this
that.
Is, you call this money.
I
this
can't
is money.
Receive money like that.
This is money.
No, you count.
I did count. I'm telling you, this is $1.
It's not
look.
$1.
You can't count simply, it's easy,
you
man.
You can't
easy. Dude, are you serious?
Because you're giving the money, you count.
I'm not doing it on purpose. This is what I have.
Then you, I'm not selling
this
you.
This is what I have.
If you can't, don't count.
You're not selling
I,
me
I'm not
because
selling
I'm
you, okay?
Bringing
I'm not selling
money.
You.
Why you gotta scream at me?
Get outside.
I'm not gonna get out. I'm just
you
trying to get my milk.
Right
I'm
now.
Just trying to get my milk.
Bring my soda up, man.
I'm just trying to get my milk,
wait,
bro.
You wait.
No, I'm not gonna wait. You,
look, you're making a big ass line.
Damn. Now you gotta look at this line. The guy turns the video camera around. This is so funny. There's a black guy. You can't see him. That's the guy that said he wants the free soda. Then you got a Hispanic guy and a Hispanic lady. The Hispanic lady looks miserable as hell. The Spanish guy kind of is laughing. There's an Asian lady or some sort of lady. She's smiling. And then there's just a regular guy just standing there. It's funny as hell, man. Now, if that was me, I would be miserable too. Like, there's like five people waiting in line. This Indian guy, he's not taking any shit. He just cleaned the house.
Come on. You're making a bet. Line.
Don't threaten me. Don't threaten me. Because I don't think you want the big fella
to
come over here. And I will come
you're
over here.
You're being so rude. You can't be treating
what?
Customers like that.
I said, don't threaten me because I will come
you.
Over there.
I'm not threatening you. All right, man. Yeah, okay, I'm you.
I don't think you want all this over there. Right. You was a little motherfucker.
You.
Are you serious? Are you serious? I got this in camera, video.
You
can't be. You can't. Insulting people.
Hey,
just let him. It's not even worth it, man. It's not even worth it. He's being a dick. He's being a dick. He's being disrespectful.
So the black guy goes behind the counter to try to beat the Indian guy up. Typical black guy. Instead of arguing, always got to use violence.
Yeah.
What do you think? You're a dick? You
big size are going to do with it. You think you got your mouth? You ain't got
you, father.
Dude, are
you...
You. Hey, it's cool. No.
Oh, so the Indian guy says, fuck you again. And wait, what just happened? I gotta rewind that a few seconds back.
What's going on?
Oh, so the guy throws something at him. I'm not sure what it was. It was a paper or something?
No.
Oh, shit. Now they threw a pen
like
at him.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
He said, fuck your father. The guy's black. He doesn't have a father.
About 10 minutes.
So now they're breaking up the guy's store now.
Milk?
Call the cops.
Are you serious, dude? Alright, look, I'll be so nice. I'm gonna count it for you.
Take your money, go back, man.
No. Yeah, you can't be good. I'm gonna count. What are you doing?
Oh, he just threw the guy's money all over the gum and over the floor. This Indian guy's fucking gangster.
Are you serious? Wow. It's unbelievable. You just threw my money. On the ground. This is gonna go on social media.
Craziness.
Damn, bro. Can I get your name? What's your name?
What you want to
know? No, what's your name? Because I want to know what's your name.
I have no name.
You shouldn't be treating customers.
His name is, he has no name.
It's like this, I'm telling you. This is what you get.
What you get?
This is what happens when you treat customers.
Damn, the Indian guy just tried to slap him. I've never seen an Indian guy this fucking angry before. This guy's not taking no shit. Notice that he didn't do it to the big black guy that got in his face. He didn't smack him, but the smaller guy has no problem smacking him now.
Are you okay?
Get out.
You can't be touching my
teeth. Go.
Dude, he's throwing the change at him now.
Dude, all I came here to do is get my milk.
You go and get
your
milk. I mean, I'm not sure what area this is in, but it must fucking suck. Who goes to a gas station to buy milk? I mean, I understand that not everyone's lucky to be like us in Pennsylvania and Philly and have Wawa everywhere, but you go to 7-Eleven, a gas station? It must be one of those fucking shit areas where there's nothing but a fucking gas station and then a couple miles away is like a 7-Eleven. That sucks.
This is not cool, man. I'm about to call the cops right now. I don't care. Whatever, bro. I'm going to call the cops. This guy's being no good. This is why you don't f***ing come to stupid people like them. It's crazy, bro.
Alright, so now the camera guy's doing his own commentary like anybody gives a shit. I'm the best guy to do commentary. You understand, motherfuckers? Alright, so this has been Public Freakouts, entitled Douchebags, recorded and recording, entitled assholes all around the world. Yes, every week there's more clips, so if you like it, stay tuned for next week and every week for Public Freakout Commentary.
JoshCast 300. I'm in National Mechanics right now in Old City, filled with douchebags, and tonight was an interesting night. Last night was okay.
Tonight was fun.
Tonight was more stuff going on. Hear the music? Yeah, groove into the mood. JoshCast 300. Everybody wants to be on the JoshCast 300. A lot of people. Sketchy characters around here. It's 1:59 a.m. Saturday night. I'm getting ready to leave in a minute or two. There is some pussy in here. I danced my ass off tonight. Yep. Lots of dancing and grooving. JoshCast 300. That's what I'm celebrating tonight. Oh yeah, yeah. Josh Cass 300. Nobody cares about my podcast, but I do, fuckers. You're not gonna stop me, fuckers. Whoa. I'm crossing these jigs like tic-tac-toe. Josh Cass is up your butt. Josh Cass is up your butt. All right, that's it. I'm leaving here. Let me get my jacket on. This is the truth. This is the truth.
Alright, the JoshCast 300 continues outside.
Damn,
leaving the National right now. People are sitting on the steps. That's the hipster spot where people sit on the steps. The hipster steps. So let's talk about last night, but I'm gonna try to get some people in the JoshCast 300. I've been a little bit social tonight. So last night I went to Center City and I wasted $5 and went to this place called Fado. It's an Irish pub. And I was debating whether I should go there or not. My initial was to go to this place called Time, my initial attention, but I didn't. So I went inside this Irish pub Fado and it was kind of dead. So I was in there for like 15, 20 minutes. I saw people leaving, so I left. And I decided to, leave. And people were like, these guys were like, oh, he's gone. And I was like, yeah, that place sucks, right, guys? Like, yeah. So after that, I was walking around, and I went to Smith's. That's the free spot. Smith's was actually really good. And, I should have stayed in there. And I didn't. JoshCast 300. I just said to this girl in the car, and she looked at me like, yeah, you go ahead. Oh, man. So I was walking around with the Smiths. Smiths turned out to be really good, so I could have just went there, and I could have just saved money. So I could have saved $5. I pretty much just wasted $5. So I was in Smiths for like about an hour or so, and I was, I was getting down, I was dancing, I didn't have any drink last night, which is cool, and a girl was kind of dancing with me a little bit, a girl too. There was a lot of coos in there, a lot of cunt, right, but I didn't, do it, I didn't do anything, as usual. I was trying to, try to fucking stay out of people's way. It was just fucking hard not to, especially these guys, they find it a spot and they just stand right next to you like a bunch of faggots. Like I said, like that was happening all night tonight. I'm on 2nd Street right now, and right outside the 7-Eleven, where all the magic happens for white folks and some black as well. JoshCast 300. So then I was in Smith's most night. Then I went to this place called Brew. Brew wasn't that good. I stood around. I saw something interesting happen last night. This guy, he approached these, I don't think they were black, they were Indian. Actually, wait, I did make an approach last night. Last night, I did, there was this very curvy black chick in there, and I tried to dance with her. I didn't touch her, but when I try to dance with her, what I do is I go up next to them, and I try to rub my butt on them. Rub my butt on their butt. It's like a test. I call it a tester. And if they want to dance with me, we usually dance. So I did that, and she didn't really go for it. She kind of just went, eh. So I walked away. Then I was in this place called Brew. There was this creepy guy in there. He was like Indian or some shit. And he kept trying to talk to these three girls, and they didn't want nothing to do with him. And he kept talking to them, and he kept like trying to touch them, and then they wanted nothing to do with him. You know what I'm saying? And eventually the girls were uncomfortable and he kept saying, no, I don't want to dance with you. And he kept talking to them like, hey, come on. And then they were trying to take a picture, and he took their camera, and he was gonna take the picture of them. And then I don't know what happened. And then after that, I saw one of the guys who worked there come over and say, hey, dude, you gotta go. I think they kicked him out, or he left, or they told him to step outside. And this guy was real creepy. I love creepy guys when they fucking approach girls, because it's so funny, because they just can't take the fucking hit, man. They just stay there and harass the girls. They get uncomfortable, and I love it, because girls are assholes, they go out for attention. So when I was a creepy guy, there's some girls, I should approach them for the JoshCast 300, but I don't think I have the balls. Alright, let's see if I have the balls. There's a lot of them. Hey! JoshCast 300. They don't even know what that is. I'm just waving my phone, so I'm like, hey, JoshCast 300. That was not a proper approach. Okay, so I stood around last night. I left early. And then I got home like 2:30 a.m. last night. Tonight, I did my concoction of vitamin water, Amsterdam vodka. I put more than usual. I put about 6 ounces, which is a lot for me. I did that. And And then I got to Center City. I was gonna go to Center City tonight. I decided, fuck that. I go to Old City. So I was in Old City for a while. I was just fucking sitting down outside for like a half an hour, fucking just fucking drinking. And I did that. And it was okay. I mean, then I went inside. I went to go pee in this pool hall spot. And staying in my usual spot. There's a guy in my usual spot. He's trying to get on the JoshCast 300. Looking inside the Cuba Libre right now. And it's pretty mobbed in there. I was thinking about going there tonight, but I didn't. So anyways, I was going to go to Center City. And maybe it would have been better at time. So anyways, yeah, that was pretty cool. Uh-oh, this chick's going to throw up, I think. This chick's going to throw up. She's trying to throw up, this girl. She looks out of it. She's got the car door open, and there it goes. There's the puke. She's just spitting. I should run up to her while she's vomiting to go, hey, you want to be on the JoshCast 300? But then she would puke in my fucking face, and I'll get sick. So, not going to do that. Yep, lots of fun out. God, man, I hate when people are just in my spot. There are just way too many guys out, man. But, yeah, so how... Hey. I said, hey, they just laughed at me. By the way, I had my Rico Suave haircut tonight. Pretty much, I got my hair cut. I finally cut off my fucking nappy, my Jew curls. And I got my beard lined up with it. So I call it the Rico Suave look. Try to say, this guy, man. All right, finally, he moves. Oh, man, these faggots. So anyways, I'm not getting anybody on the JoshCast 300. I am pussying out. I'm saying hi to people, but I got to say, hey, you want to be on my show? I got to be more persistent, but I'm going to try to get somebody on. Somebody will be on tonight. If not, well, then I failed. Who cares? No one's going to listen to this anyways. I tried my hardest for this show. People who claim to be my friends don't want to be on. Okay. This guy almost got run over. It's pretty cold out here. Okay. So, tonight, I did my Amsterdam vodka thing, like I said, and I went to go pee in this pool hall, then I went to National Mechanics, that's the bar that bounces to make fun of me, and they were just like, hey, you look good, so I'm like, you look good, man, you got your hair cut, you look fresh and everything, you should. This is the way you should always look, they're complimenting me, I said, thanks. So I was in there, and there was this, I went to go pee, there was this chubby girl, and this chick is out of it, she's puking right now, as I said before. And this guy's taking pictures of her, shaming her. Is that person alive? So. This girl's mad. She opened up the car door and said, yo, get the fuck off Snapchat. This guy's shaming her. This guy who's got a small dick. Oh, shit. Big truck just pulled up of Hudson's bread. And, yeah, this chick's fucking puking right now. It's blagging. She had too much Popeyes and Hennessy. Anyways, so there was this chubby chick in there. She wasn't attractive. She had curly hair with big titties, but she was by herself. So I danced on her, right? So I danced on her. And we danced for like maybe like 10, 20 seconds. And I said, hey, what's up? What are you up to? And we started talking. And it turns out she's by herself. And I said, oh, that's cool. You're by yourself, right? And she's like, yeah, yeah. And I was like, it looks like you're leaving. She's like, yeah, I'm leaving. And I was like, can I leave with you? I made a bold move. I said, yeah, can I leave with you? And she said, yeah, you can if you want. She's like, I have to, she said something like, I have to pick up my stepdad or something. Yo, what's up, guys? Guys, want to be on the JoshCast? Nobody knows what that is. I told you no one knows. This guy knows. JoshCast. Yeah, man. Doesn't hurt to ask. This guy gave me a fist bump. See, no one knows the JoshCast. See, I did ask. Those guys were like, what the fuck is that? So I was talking to her and I said, can I leave with you? So I danced with her for a little bit. She said she lived outside the city, like where Ben Salem was. I said, okay. And we were talking for a little bit. I could tell she wanted to get away from me because she was on her phone, right? She was on her phone, and all of a sudden she was like, oh, I gotta go. She's like, my friend is, wait, whatever. She ran away. So I knew something was up. So she ran away. Not ran, but you know, she left. And I knew she wasn't gonna come back. So that usually happens when they make up the excuse, you know, like, hey, I'm gonna get ready to leave or something, or I have to go to the bathroom. There's always some excuse, and then they leave. No one knows what the JoshCast 300 is. People need to respect the JoshCast 300. Yeah, there was lots of coups out here. If I would have went to Center City, would have been better. I was gonna go to this place called Time. It's a jazz spot where it has like jazz on the first floor, dance floor. So anyways, after that, I talked to the bouncer. I said, well, I did make an approach tonight. I said, I did try to talk to this girl, but she was by herself, but she wasn't interested. He's like, oh, man. So in there, I had a really, really good vibe going. I was dancing by myself. And this bachelorette party girl, she's part of this blonde chick, she was dancing with me a little bit. Also, I was just dancing around. There was this really sexy black girl there. She was skinny, very curvy. And I told her, I said, you're the best dancer in here. And she said, oh, thanks, I'm not even dancing. I said, yeah, well, that means something. I was like, you're really good. So, it's cool. All right, what's up, man? You want to be on the JoshCast? Uh-huh. JoshCast 300 episode. This guy don't know what it is either. See, no one has heard of this. Everyone's just like being polite, like, oh, that wasn't me on the JoshCast 300. What I gotta do is talk to people. See, I gotta not ask people if they want to be on. I gotta just talk to them like a regular conversation, and then they'll be on the show. But see, I'm being social. You guys are hearing it. I'm trying. You heard it. I did. Well, the alcohol did help. I was trying, but listen. Okay. Lots of hoes now are now leaving the bar. They got their coats. So yeah, I was in there. So I left at Ashton Mechanics. I went to this place called Plow with the Stars. Didn't really see any girls in there that I liked or anything. The dance, it was pretty crowded. It was mostly like a party in there. Left there, then I went to Lucha Cartel. Inside the Lucha Cartel, that's a salsa spot. It was just all groups. I left there, I went to go pee in this disgusted bathroom at Stowe's. And then I went back to National Mechanics, and I didn't do anything. The major bouncer was like, you need to stay in here, man. He's the cool one. He's the guy who doesn't really... And he was like, come on, man, you got to do some stuff. And I told him, I said, look, man, I'm trying my fucking best. I was like, there's not much to really do, man. I was like, I'm trying. I was like, I tried tonight. I asked this one chick by herself if she wanted to leave. I was going to actually take her out and show her some spots. She had no interest. You know, I did approach another sexy Hispanic-looking chick with a sexy body. I told her she was a good dancer. Yo, he's pointing that guy right there. Is that your ride, dude? This guy's out of it. This one guy's looking for a ride. I thought that was his ride. I was trying to help him. But anyways, there's three guys. So yeah, I was inside that National Case. I saw some RSD guys. Those are the pickup guys. I don't know them. This one guy, I call him the Chicken McNugget. He's a short black guy. Oh, I still see the black girls puke. So many black girls puking in Old City, right? So I did see some pickup guys in there, and they were standing, of course, right next to me. They didn't know who I am, though. There might have been one that recognized me, I don't know. But I moved away from them, and then there's always these three Hispanic guys in there. One of them wears a tank top. You guys can tell he's got to show off his muscles. It's like 30 degrees outside. He's wearing a tank top because he's got to show off his fucking muscles. And, you know, I wasn't doing much in there. I think I did talk to this one girl at the bar that the bouncer was like, talk to her. And I was like, hey, what's up? She's like, what's up? And I was like, what are you up to? She's like, I'm getting a drink. I said, well, how's your night going? She's like, I'm good. I just got back with my boyfriend. We just got back to Philly. And I said, okay, that's pretty cool. And I was like, well, see ya. So I was social tonight. And then that was when I took my phone out. So I do it at JC300 Sober Commentary with Drunk People. So I did try. Tried more than I should have. Okay, also another thing that happened tonight, there was these two chunky black chicks. I know it's always black chicks, but last night and tonight I did interact with some white girls, so I'm not always with the black chicks, but as I said before, they are easy to dance with. But anyways, so there was these two chunky black chicks, and I heard that one of them say at a store, she was like, she said something like, I'm going to curse this guy out, because last time I was arguing, I said, oh, you going to curse this guy out? Can I follow you in and do a public freak out? Can I pull my phone out, put it on Worldstar? And she laughed and said, no, I don't want you to do that. So I went inside Plow, and then when I came out of Plow, her and her friend was sitting outside. I said, did you curse the guy out? She's like, no, but I got two free black and milds and stuff like that. I said, cool. And I was going to stay and talk to them, but I didn't, because, you know, they didn't want nothing to do with me. So anyways, I got my new stupid haircut. I'm still a fat fucking slob that smells like farts. But listen, folks, I'm not trying to get laid. I want to make more of my nights. I want this segment to be better. This sober commentary with drunk people. I want things. Yeah, I want it to be better. And I'm trying. I'm getting there slowly. But like I said, if having a wingman, that also helps as well. You ladies want to be on the JoshCast? 300 episodes. They laughed. No one knows the JoshCast. They will someday. Someday, these girls will look at the show and go, what is this shit, and turn it off. I think I recognized that big... Oh, yeah, I think I recognized that big chick before. I met her at Cuba Libre. She was with a group of guys. I think I danced with her. It's 2:18 right now. How many people... I approached about four groups of people tonight. And I didn't get anybody on the JoshCast 300, as promised. I promised myself I would go crazy, but the alcohol is wearing off. I did drink around... I got drunk like around 10... I was done around 10:45. So that was, what, 3 hours ago? 3.5 hours ago? So, yeah, it's... I'm yapping right now. I can yap. As far as what's going on in the street action, there's cop cars up there. I think there's obviously a fight. Either a fight or somebody got hurt. They didn't see any fights tonight. Pretty, I guess you could say, cool vibe. I was thinking about going there tonight. But see, the problem is they pat you down. And I don't like spots like that, you know. Because it's not that I'm bringing anything in there. But, you know, I had my baby wipes on me. I was going to go to this black spot, Cuba, Blue Martini. But they pat you down. And imagine a black guy looking at me like, what's this shit? I'm like, oh, baby wipes? What's that? For my asshole. You can't come in here, man. You can't be bringing that shit in here. Like, all right, man. I see these two hoes that always go to Cuba Libre. It's amazing how it's the same hoes. South Second Street is mobbed with taxis, mobbed with Ubers. Cars are... A taxi just ran up on the sidewalk. That's so fucking savage. He just drove up on the sidewalk. He wants to be on the JoshCast 300. Man, oh, man. So... All in all, last night was a decent night. The only regret I had last night was I spent $5. Tonight, I spent no money. So, if I would have spent no money last night, this would have been the first Friday and Saturday since God knows when, I would have spent any money. Outside the Blue Martini, there is some young hoes. These cars are just running into each other. The car just, boom, almost popped this tire driving by the sidewalk. This big GMC white van. I want you all to close your eyes as I explain to you the JoshCast. Close your eyes and imagine a podcast where it's a guy who has no life and can't get laid. Yeah, I ate some chicken quesadillas earlier and I had some spaghetti and meatballs a few hours later, so I didn't eat nothing else all day. I really hope I don't... Well, I should be able to make it home. I think this guy almost sneezed on me earlier. It was pretty gross. I felt it like on the back of my neck. But I moved away from the guy. But hopefully not. I think I see a comedian guy. Is that a comedian guy? If it is, why is he by himself? Hi, you want to be on the JoshCast 300? It's my 300 podcast episode. Thank you. Have a good night. The woman just shook her head and looked at me like with disgust. I love this show. It's the best. Here comes the rest of her clip. She's walking away. She's like, this guy's a weirdo.
We can't stay long because we got to get to the after. We got weed to smoke.
You heard it there, folks. Smay's got a weed to smoke. Oh, shit. It's 2:21 right now. I got about... My train's going to come in probably a few minutes. I just farted. My stomach is starting to... Not to say hurt, but, starting to ache. I was thinking about getting a slice of pizza. I always think about getting a pizza when I'm drunk. That's the thing. But I didn't. So, I'm going to wrap up. Once again, I failed, everybody. Failed JoshCast 300 Sober Kaiser Drunk People. I did try, though. I asked about 5 or 6 groups of people or people. The bus was going to turn. The bus can't even get through. It is mobbed. And on top of that, the street's blocked off. So if you're an Uber driver, you are fucked. You drove down here, and now you're stuck. Anyways, this is JoshCast 300. Failed Sober Kaiser Drunk People. I did ask people, though. You can't say I pussied out. I did ask people, but nobody knows what it is. Nobody wants to be on it. Next time, if I do this next week, this segment, which I hope to do again, where I try to get people on the show, one thing I realize is you just talk to people. They don't even realize, you know, I'm on the phone. Just talk to people. Don't even tell them it's JoshCast. Trick them on the show. Should have did that, but should have, could have, would have. This is it. I'm going home, and that's it. It's cold. All right. See ya, fuckos. Okay, I'm at the train station right now. There's a couple arguing across from me. I don't know what's going on. A man is very mad at his lady. Let's listen. That's what the fuck you did. And that's what the fuck you did. I don't give a fuck. That's not funny to him. What the fuck do you mean, why? Yeah, this guy's yelling at his chick. She did something. Yeah, this guy, he's pissed. He's not having it. And rightfully so. I'm not sure exactly what she did, but he's not putting up with it. Now they stop arguing now. All right. So, maybe they knew what I was doing. I wasn't looking at them, though. I was looking away. But, all right, this is it. All right, now they're arguing real loud. Listen. The guy snapped at her, and then she yelled back. So I guess the argument is she was walking in the wrong direction. And he's worried about her. Well, that means he loves her. I heard if a man punches a lady in the face, it means he really cares about you. It's on you, bitch. She doesn't give a fuck. That's the problem. It's not that she walked away. It's that she doesn't give a fuck. He said, jump in front of the fucking train. And now she's saying, grow the fuck up. Suck my fucking dick, he said. She said, bitch, I paid for that house. I'm pretty sure she has sucked his dick before, though. I mean, so to tell your girlfriend to suck my dick or your wife, I mean, she obviously has sucked it, right? I mean, it's not an insult. You say it to a girl you don't know. Like, if I say that to a girl I don't know, that's an insult because she hasn't sucked my dick. I can't hear them anymore now. I don't know what's going on. You said, bitch, jump in front of the fucking train. Man, that's vicious. What if she did it? He would be held responsible. You know, in today's WIF society, if you tell someone to jump in front of a train and they jump, you can get arrested for that. Remember that news story where that girl told that guy who had a mental disorder, she said, you know, why don't you do the world a favor and kill yourself? And then he killed himself, and then she got prosecuted. So if you tell someone to jump in front of a train and they jump, that means you're dead. I mean, that means you should be arrested. They're still fighting, but you can't hear it. Anyways, if anything else happens, you're going to hear it. JoshCast 300. Okay, so it's 2:29. I'm still waiting for the train. I think that, the report, what happened with the incident, the guy, I think, punched the box. He punched something. One of those boxes on the wall, I guess, and then he walked away from the chick, and I hear her screaming, how am I going to get home? He says, hey, why don't you suck some nigga's dick? I'm just waiting for the train right now. I'm bored. What are you folks doing right now? Write in the comment section. All right. Well, that's good. Well, that's good enough. I that's the coverage I have right now. So, okay.
We're here at the Wednesday night County Cabaret Open Night. Oh, we're sitting in Kier Williams' spot.
Let's let him sit here.
Yep. Kier,
this is your spot.
Let the king get his seat.
Thank you. Kier.
Oh. This is the JoshCast 300, damn it.
Yay. Why am I the only one clapping, by the way?
Yeah, 300 episodes. Thank you so much.
He's the first,
that's amazing.
Like, first podcast now, in Philadelphia.
I'm not a quality guy. I'm a quantity guy. It's not a good podcast, but it's,
I love quantity.
Yeah, but this is the first one.
You come off
big
heaping
piles.
This is the first podcast. You want me to cut the music? No, I like it in the background because it comes out real good on this.
Okay.
I'm going to get a YouTube strike, but it's okay. So
you shouldn't have said that.
Yeah, you've been on many episodes of the show. You remember when I first started bringing my little blue dildo microphone?
I remember the first episode that I did with you. I was actually, I just met you, and then I went to New York that weekend, and I called you from Brooklyn.
Yeah.
That's awesome, from Brooklyn on your thing. And to
well,
me,
as you know, Darin didn't know any comedian but me, so he used to actually talk to me.
It was you and Mike Logan. It was the only two
he would mess with your face
and
ask me for advice.
Those were the first two
he didn't know with the maniac he was dealing with.
He
so
found
that's
out there were other comics, and he quickly moved away.
Until the second time he saw me before, he realized what a racist I was, and he was like, oh, shit, I was asking this guy for
advice. That's not true. That's not true. Even to today, I'm the one guy's saying Jack Boo.
That's true. He doesn't.
That's true.
But I think you're saying a different version of that word, don't you?
I say Joshy Jackson Boo when
no,
I
mean,
see you the first time.
All right. So.
Yeah. Whenever I see you, I say what's up, Joshy Jackson Boo, and I don't know why.
That's
I said
right.
That.
You got like the unruly version of his facial hair.
We were talking about facial hair earlier.
Yeah, we're talking about it.
Because he's got. He was saying, you know, he's
happy. I got my Rico Suave look, you know, right now. I would get it once a year, because it's good for my skin. Because I get razor burn. You can get me the freshest razor. If I shave with it, I get bumps all over my neck. I used to, in my first year of college, I had bumps all over my neck.
Damn.
It looked like a beehive. And I would pop them. I would pop them in class, and then I would go to the bathroom, and it was all a...
Oh!
Like,
yeah, probably
disgusting.
Like a beehive.
Listen, can I tune this guitar tonight? Yes! Can you do that to each one of my jokes tonight, bro? Like the Tonight Show? Like, yeah, I heard the news today. North Korea.
Maybe he'll play everybody on.
Show starting tonight. Big crowd here tonight, the Northeast Cabaret. One female audience member that's going to be disgusted and never come back again. But somebody will get laid tonight, and it's going to be a tall, handsome son of a gun.
First of all, he brought this girl here, and she's like, you know, oh, she's a girl.
Is this a new girl, or is this... Or is
oh,
this
I'm pretty sure. Based on his act, he gets a new one every single week. It's got to be true. He says he just walks up to a girl's in a bar and says hi. I tried that for 10 years. I only made out with fat girls, and they still didn't fuck me.
Well, at least you made
it's
out
true.
With them.
Boy, yeah, but that was
talking,
when I was.
Are you talking in the bars?
Yeah.
You bring them home to make.
No, nah, I never brought them home. I don't have a place to bring them home. I made out with them at the bar.
Scott Terry coming in.
Scott Terry doesn't like. He's paranoid. Scott Terry was on episode where he said some things and he told me to take it off.
All right, that happens. I had a couple.
He was drunk.
Some of the original interviews that we did.
He was afraid a black guy was on here and beat him up, and I told him I don't know any black people. People are so paranoid it comes to everyone thinks I'm trying to get somebody set up. It's like, I don't know any club owners. I don't have Facebook anymore. No one's going to listen to this. No, I still have it, but I deleted everybody off just because nobody's listening to my shitty podcast. And on top of that, people would tell me they like my offensive statuses, but they were afraid to like you because they didn't want people to hear it. And it's just all people from here.
They send you messages.
Which makes no sense.
I like that one stat. That's they hilarious. Copy and paste it in the message. I wanted to hit like, but this is the message. This is the
yeah.
That's absurd.
Yeah.
Does this go anywhere? You just leave this on your phone.
No. I put them on YouTube, iTunes,
really?
Stitcher.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
He doesn't know about the dry hump king, apparently.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
This guy's a dry hump king.
The first video I ever shot, the dry hump in my bed, it has 300 something thousand likes right now. You can watch it on your phone if you want.
Yeah.
And I was 20 years old. I was just testing out my camera.
Just humping a bed.
Still to
this
day.
That's the first thing you thought of.
Still to this day, that's the best, the most views I ever got.
The most notoriety you've ever had.
If Ryan was smart right now, he'd just turn around.
Scott Terry, I'm doing a JoshCast 300.
What?
The JoshCast 300.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
My 300 episode. Say hi. This
Hello.
Is it. Little penis microphone.
Congratulations.
Now, Scott, I've taken you more off more episodes than anybody.
Yeah.
Remember? Remember the answer with the car? You were saying some things. And
Yeah.
You probably think I'm trying to set you up. No, I'm not on Facebook anymore, Scott.
Why not?
I defriended everybody because I was getting too racist on there. No, people were fake to like my
did
status.
Did they put you in Facebook jail?
Or? No, I delete myself. I mean, I still have it. I just got rid of it. I deleted everything.
That's great. I haven't seen you on there.
That's how irrelevant. I mean, nobody realized I'm off Facebook. Darin doesn't know. He's like, wait, you're off Facebook? I've been off for 6 months.
Nobody
not a single person.
Me either if I went off Facebook.
If I die, they would be like, oh, he died? Like, 2 years died? Later.
I just saw him last week. What do you mean he died?
Yep.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're going to record on stage? You're going to bring that up and leave your set on the podcast?
Well, I don't play my sets on the podcast unless something happens, but nothing ever happens here, unfortunately. People get offended.
Comedy Cabaret, Northeast Philly.
But no one ever gets to talk about your new two?
I don't have a joke for it.
You should? No, but I mean on there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We talked about it before we got
it. I like it, man. It works.
Thanks. But to see it's already growing back right here, so I have to shave it.
Just shave it. Yeah. Keep it shaped up.
All right, we're going to start the show now. Thank you, guys. Josh.
Oh, JoshCast 300. We have one audience member, two guests, and an abysmal host. Folks, here it is.
I suppose I have to raise this camera up. This is terrible editing. In order to get us in the frame. There we go. Am I in there?
Yes.
All right. First guest coming on is Bill Miller.
Hey. Oh, yeah, it's great to be here. You can stop playing music.
There you go.
I get the music.
And our second guest, he's dressed for the occasion, everybody. Will Fitz. Have a seat, guys.
I like the fake host voice. Hey, it's Will Fitz.
Will Fitz. So wait, this is...
It's like a projector.
Am I supposed to do something special for this? This is supposed to be a special episode, right?
Yeah, 300.
All right, let's do it. Here it is.
All right.
Here's the special episode. You fucking want it?
That's gross.
No. You want it?
No.
Yeah.
No. This is weird.
Right. Yeah, this is the episode. Come on, do my
back. Oh, this is disgusting. No.
Come on, no. Do the back.
No,
okay. Do the back.
No, don't touch me.
Here it is.
Oh my god.
JoshCast 300.
That's the same smell.
300.
I recognize that smell from the strip club.
This is like alien shit. You can't get this stuff off.
No. Oh my god, that's disgusting.
Where did I put the cap? Didn't we see the cap?
I really wish I was one.
I thought that was a bottle of vodka.
I wish.
Oh no.
I wish I was told this was going to happen. Bro. Did you bring a mop?
Let's get a close up of this before the thumbnail.
You need a,
Alright. No, don't get you have to get a mop. Now my
No, no, no. You sit down. You sit down. You made your bet, young man. And you're
going to sit... brought to you by Taco Bell.
You're Bert Kreischer now.
Alright, yeah, you're right.
You're Bert Kreischer.
I'll use that for... It would dry at the time. Because, you know, baby oil... You guys ever jerk off the porn watch with baby oil?
You are disgusting.
It actually dries.
You're putting that shirt back on?
Yeah.
You should do the rest of the podcast with your shirt on.
Alright, maybe
Lord.
Alright. Mike comes in here, he's gonna be like, what the fuck is going on here? Well,
he's not gonna leave.
I got some baby oil here on the stage. But what are you gonna do? That's the only idea I had to make this special.
You can just mention that it's the 300th episode.
Here's the thing, I already have over 2 hours of content for this episode. Okay. So with this is gonna be 3 hours. No one's gonna listen to this or watch
it. You have a hairy chest.
Well, I do. No, I used to shave my hair.
You shaved it?
And then I realized I was being a queer. That's still offensive, right?
Well,
I was being a metrosexual.
What you mean is you were being a burden. You were being a burden on your family, not being bestowing your...
See, folks, I'm cleaning up my act.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah.
And I thought you had a really good set last night, and
thanks.
This just ruined.
I don't think anybody thought I was a comedy genius last night after that, because you know open mics you can kill it one night and then go that way, so you know, it's or the next night even.
You did really well. You really tore the room apart.
Well, yeah, last night I did a joke about how white burn victims look better than black burn victims.
Okay. Yeah,
Ed McGonagall. Yeah, McGonagall thought it was funny, and the punchline is because I see black guys with these. This burnt skin, and I was like, it looks like someone dumped Pepto-Bismol. That's something I added to the joke.
Okay.
And then the room was shocked, and people started laughing. And then I made it funnier because I was like, you can't do that in the city because they're cutting your mic off over here. And it's true, because when I first came here, I thought I was going to get banned, because I saw all these old middle-aged guys, like Kenzo. I didn't know who Kenzo was, and I was like, they're going to ban me. These old guys aren't going to like this stuff. But then I came back the next week, and I was like, oh, hey, Josh, it was so nice to me. Aww.
Well, also, too, by comparison, we also had a guy who was an admitted, like, school teacher, like, kind of almost threatening to rape and stalk the girl.
He doesn't teach. That works in the lunchroom.
That was a comedy contest.
And that's not a burn on people that work in the lunchroom.
No.
But people that claim that when they work in a school that you think they may be a teacher, which is like the first guess. But yeah, so you couldn't be as bad as that. But I thought you were genuinely.
Wait a minute! Good. You show me a hot chick, I'm all loaded, I'm all oiled up. Come on, let's get it cranking up here, guys. First guy to get hard is gay. Too late. Okay. No, but yeah, that's the thing is, I'm not always the dirtiest. Even before I was going to this room, we had Rocco Sperling. We had this comedian, Joe Mayo. He kind of talked like this. He had a raspy voice, like, yeah, so the other day, this fucking old cunt, the other day. He kind of talked, he had like the smoker's voice. He did raunchy stuff. Mike Rainey, he was dropping the N-bomb. So even if I didn't go to this room, it would still be this.
Yeah.
I just added an ethnic background, so you don't know where it is. You don't know if it's funny or not, but that, it hasn't helped. Because people are like, is he black? Is he Hispanic? Is he? Either way, they're offended. But some liberals won't call me out because they're like, I don't know what that guy is.
Yeah.
We don't want to ban him, but then he might bring a whole Hispanic gang down here with their pickets.
Yeah. So they don't want to be racist for banning the one or one of the few minorities they may have there, but you're saying that the reason they don't want to ban you to be racist is because they're also thinking racist that,
can you look me in the eyes, please?
That not racist. So, look up here.
You don't have to look at my boobs, just look at
them. Well,
I can't stop looking at
them. I don't make that.
Oh my
contact.
God. I wish I could do the thing I see with the...
the Arnold thing?
Yeah.
I can kind of.
You guys talk for a minute. I'm gonna get cleaned up over here.
You know, I'm kind of jealous. He has such a hairy chest. I don't have a hairy chest, so I got a big stupid tattoo instead.
Oh, is it like a big sea ship, like a nautical?
Almost.
Place,
take it off. Let's see. This is the 300th episode. Now, Will, I know you don't have to. You're not gonna do it, but.
Oh, Will's gonna do it. He's gonna take all his pants.
Oh wow! You only have like five hairs on top.
I know.
And you have a little bit of belly. You're like a chick.
I have the body type of a fat girl with a pretty face.
I was gonna say you have. You look like an Italian woman. You know, Italian women. They're kind of hairy. And Hispanic women. I used to see hot Italian Hispanic women in my class, and then when they're, you know, girls, they bend over forward. You would look at their, you know, kind of look at their ass, but you would see the hair on their back. And you go, oh, there would be so much hair.
Why'd you put your shirt back on?
Well, okay, let's compare them. Let's take it off. I just want to clean up. This would be a good thumbnail. Move closer to Will Fitz. He likes it.
Will Fitz sits in the middle.
Closer to the frame. There it is. This is the evolution chart. Will Fitz is the man in the suit. This is what man used to look like. And then this is the new generation of men who don't take care of their bodies.
I could do the Arnold thing.
Yeah.
I do this.
And you were saying
I kind of do that to myself. To
you
sleep.
Were saying you didn't want it to look myself. Gay or anything. That was like,
what did it look gay?
No, well you said something earlier about that. But it's like and now.
I said it wouldn't sound homophobic, right?
No, this isn't homophobic.
No,
at all.
You called something queer.
This is very. Okay. This is very comfortable all with right, your
well, listen,
with your body, your sexuality,
yeah.
Your personality.
I mean, this is only for the 300th episode. I promise to keep my clothes on from now on.
Hashtag burnt Chrysler. We're doing the burnt Chrysler.
That's right. Works for that guy. I just need to find
you. You know what? He doesn't have like the shapes. He's just one big freaking D.
Oh, here's the cap I got.
He's got like the barrel chested fat of a sunrise.
So how's the show going so far? It's not bad. At least I did something for it, right?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
This is dedication. I'm shaming myself up here. You can sit down now, Bill.
Alright.
Now, Bill, you got drunk last time.
Last night?
Well, every night.
I can't believe I bombed in front of Ryan's hot girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, so comedian last night, Ryan Foster, brought a smoking hot chick. You should have been here last night.
And he fucking killed it.
He was funny.
I'm so fucking proud of that guy. He brought his hot girlfriend.
She was like,
she didn't look at his notes. He was a complete stream of consciousness. Right. Dude, good on that guy.
Yeah, she was hot, man. And he always goofs on comedians for bringing their chicks. He said that. He said, I can never do that, but he finally did it last night.
And we all ripped on him.
But he's a good looking guy, so even if he bombed, I highly doubt she would have been like, you know that like the episode of Seinfeld? I can't respect what you do. You ever see that when Jerry, the girl breaks up with him because he bombed at open mic? She goes, he goes, but you're a waitress. You're a waitress.
He's such a good looking guy that, Ryan, not Jerry Seinfeld, he's such a good looking guy that girls would suck his dick even if he was uncircumcised.
Yeah, I wouldn't give respect to Jerry Seinfeld because he has a big penis and he was banging a 17-year-old in his 40s.
Really?
Yeah.
I gotta believe that.
He was. It was on Howard Stern. Yeah.
Really?
Howard Stern was making fun of him, and then that's how they kind of stopped being friends. He left a voicemail on his answer machine because Jerry wanted to take his calls, and they were goofing on him. Jackie wrote a song about him, and he didn't say, you know, Jerry doesn't have a sense of humor like that.
He was probably like, 17! It was only 4 months!
It's legal! It's barely legal! She's old enough to go to prom! I brought her home by 12!
Her parents are nice people!
I can tell Will doesn't want to do the show anymore, but he's already dressed up. Now, why did you dress up for this? Is this for the 300th episode, or you just like to dress like this?
Oh, it's a combo. It was the 300th. I wasn't sure for some reason.
Horrible. Fashion.
Plus, I just have lots of suits for work, so I can do that, too. It's
You're the only guy I know who's unemployed who dresses better than like, you're not. You don't want to give that look of, you're like, I'm unemployed, but I'm going to dress like a...
Yeah.
It's good.
Dress for the job you want, not the job you have.
Speaking of that.
Where'd you get those glasses from? Bruce Valanche?
Well, at least it wasn't a...
You don't like Bruce Valanche?
It wasn't a Sally Jesse comment, which I've got from my dad.
Sally Jesse.
He's like,
that's a good burn.
Yeah.
Check out my cum tissues right there, nice and dry. Give it up for cum tissues.
Are they in frame? I don't think they're in
frame. No, they're not frame. Let's leave them there.
Okay, this is going to be
blurry, out of focus.
For our next segment.
Get my cum tissues.
For our next segment, we're all going to take a wad of cum tissues. And we're going to do the test. We're going to each wipe our ass. And whoever has the dirtiest ass...
That's without me.
...wins.
I had 2 tacos at the bar, plus I ate a cheesesteak earlier.
Now grab some of these Luby tissues.
I'll put them back. That was a funny bit, though.
Oh, thank you very much.
I appreciate you touching those things. I've been off my disgusting, sweaty body.
It smells like a fucking strip club.
Yeah. You know, girls, I wouldn't say girls are, well, girls are not into me. But, you know, like those guys in strip clubs, like they're all baby oiled up. Like, girl, it's amazing how you can take some. I was watching Robin Big and the big black guy who died, Big Black Boykin. You never heard of Big Black?
No, I don't.
Christopher Big, he was in Rob, the one artist member Cox, he knows.
Isn't he dead?
Yeah, he's dead, he just passed away. But he used to be a stripper, so he went back to his stripper days, and he's fat. Okay. And girls were still cheering him on, he was all wiggled up, he stuffed his speedo with 2 socks, even though he's black because he was nervous.
Guys, that wasn't Big Black, that was some other black guy.
Probably.
He just said, I'm Big Black! You know, he's some guy that works in the kitchen, and everyone believed it. Who's gonna say no?
That's true.
He played the part well.
He did.
He said, "I'm Big Black," and then the guy in the microphone was like, "Everybody is Big Black from Robin Big."
Well, they announced him for Robin Big. I think his name was Black Lavender. That was his stripper name.
Black Lavender.
It reminds me of Bad Grandpa, Johnny Knoxville. Remember what's in that black stripper with the guys? Yeah, have you seen Bad Grandpa?
No.
So Johnny Knoxville is in character the whole movie, and his, I forgot the character's name, he goes to a black guy strip club, and where girls go to see him, and at first he's like complimenting him and stuff, and he says to one of the black guys, I bet you got a big tootsie roll, and the black guy tries to beat up, and then
he takes a shit,
and then he goes up on stage and pulls his whole dick out, he's the only white guy,
And he just takes his dick out. At first, the girls thought it was like not, they weren't into it, but they were like, oh my God. And then I think the bouncers were in on it. But then when he took his dick out, like, get the fuck out of here. And they all threw him out. And he's like, but he's this old guy, so they couldn't really toss him out. They had to like push him out. That's probably the best scene in the whole movie. Shock comedy, folks. That's how you get the views from the kids on the YouTubes. This is going to get no views, because who wants to see me?
Sure. Well, that's the, you don't know until you click it. If you use that as a thumbnail, then yeah.
I will, but even though it looked interesting, people still like, yeah, but I want to see that guy though, you know? Like, I should have brought that Ryan guy with his chick and just had her on stage. She could do nothing but smile and they'll get like an extra 200-300 views. Mm-hmm. This guy's reading a paper in the middle of the show. Someone's preparing. That's cool. I want to talk about. I know Big Jay Ogerson, or Dan Soder. I want to talk about this movie. You guys ever see It Happens? I don't think I've asked you that. You haven't seen it. Are you just saying no, Will?
No, what is,
what about you?
No, I haven't seen It Happens.
Audience member, It Happens. It came out in 2014, so the premise of the movie is this beginning of the movie, this beginning of the scene, this woman has heels on. She runs out of her house in a teddy, and she's freaking out, and then she ends up dead on a beach, and then this guy he dates this girl. They have sex in the back of his car, and
it
then
follows.
You heard of it?
It follows.
It happens. I'm drunk.
Yeah,
I think I seen that in the theater actually.
Yeah, something did happen, right?
Nothing happened. Well, no, because
no,
as soon as you're saying it happens, I'm just thinking of the Forrest Gump scene. It's like, what shit?
It happens.
It follows. Yeah, I didn't see it, but I heard about that. It's like the ghost of social media or something. Or STD ghost. You gotta fuck someone else to get rid of the ghost.
Yes.
Before it slowly follows you and kills you or something.
Yeah, and then the guy goes to a prostitute, which is like a genius. Because then that prostitute's going to spread it to somebody, then they're going to spread it, and then everyone's going to be followed.
Okay, so now I don't have to say it.
No, well, I spoiled the movie. But if you watch it on, you know, to watch those top 10 lists, watch Mojo, you know, you ever see those top 10 horror movie things? It's all over the list. They pretty much give away everything.
Yeah, and so I don't watch too many of them or whatever, or watch ones that...
I don't know. I was doing a podcast called TV Movie Experts, and this guy quit. So I'm the only expert left. Well, me and Bill Miller.
I'm great at watching movies.
I don't been watching too much TV shows though. I don't have time.
Yeah, I just finished watching the new Twin Peaks, which is. Meh.
What is that?
It reminds me of this podcast.
David Lynch, weird, like.
This baby.
You're banned. This is what got you banned, not the baby oil on the stage.
Okay, go ahead. Explain.
We're gonna mop it up.
Explain what Twin Peaks is. Why I get these jizz tissues?
We're gonna mop it up.
Twin Peaks came out in the early '90s by David Lynch, the guy that did Eraserhead and Dune. Just a very artsy. Goofball director and a big advocate of transcendental meditation, like where you pay thousands of dollars to sit there and do nothing. It was a series in the 90s about like a little small town, Twin Peaks, Washington, where a girl was found raped and murdered. And they were wondering who killed her. And then so everybody's wondering.
Everyone's least favorite way to find a young lady.
Yeah.
No one likes to see one of those.
So there was just a lot of like, you know, it was like a whodunit thing, but also the town was very weird, and because that was the David Lynch stuff coming through, that there's a lady that carried a log who also wore these glasses, like Sally Jesse Raphael, just bizarre stuff too, like very metaphysical and goofy and artsy, and it ended like. Like, just not making any sense. Everybody's just like, what the? It was one of those series that he left it deliberately with all these crazy questions. And now 25 years later, they get, just like all these other shows that are making a comeback, Roseanne and even Arrested Development and Futurama after just a few years, So they brought it back.
They brought back Roseanne, though John Goodman died on it, right?
Yeah, yeah.
He died on the show?
No, the last episode, he died of a heart attack.
He died?
Yeah.
No, he just didn't have a heart attack, and then it was like, end of the show.
He's a ghost now.
Well, no, because originally Roseanne did a fake out thing where they won the lottery and then they were like rolling in dough and doing great, and then they found out, oh no, that was a, because people were also like, hey, we like the show because it was blue collar and made sense. This is a cop out way to like end and make it like, hey, and they lived as millionaires. Instead it was like, oh, this is a dream.
I was fine with that, by the way.
Yeah, but no, they're like, this is a dream in Dan's coma because he had a heart attack, and oh, he didn't make it, he's dead. So it ends with that.
But I saw him in the new show.
Yeah, because it comes back, and then it turns out Roseanne was dreaming. Doing some crazy scene elsewhere.
You know what? It was an ayahuasca dream.
Yeah. Well, no, that's... Have you heard of the Timmy Westfaller universe theory that in the... What was it? It was at St. Elsewhere or something hospital, General Hospital. There's a... It was a TV series in the 80s, and it had special guests from all these other shows. Like, it had Detective Munch, who later appeared in Homicide, Life on the Streets, and Law and Order. It had, people from MASH, people from Taxi. It had all these crossovers. And then even those shows that crossed over, so like Simpsons was in something else, so it all ties together, and it turns out by the end of the series, it's revealed that the whole hospital sequence was the, imagine it, like it pulls out into a snow globe, and it turns out this autistic kid was imagining it the whole time. So it means that everything, all TV series that ever had a crossover, which is... Somewhere in the, it's over 300 shows.
The Drew Carey show.
Yeah.
Crossed over with Roseanne.
So Coach. And somehow, somehow that connects back to MASH or some other crap. And it all takes place in an autistic kid looking at a snow globe and stuff. So it was something like that. And that's basically like, there's an element of that to Twin Peaks where it's just like.
That autistic kid has amazing writing. Mm-hmm. Like groundbreaking, fucking award-winning writing, just spinning around in his autistic little brain, his beautiful little mind.
Yeah. Now we have an audience member, we can do improv now.
Okay.
Let's do it. Ask him.
Yeah, it's like we need a suggestion from the audience. Make the show good.
We just pretend there's more people. Wait, let me make sure this frame. Okay, this is frame. Good. All right. The camera actually looks slimmer now. I'm out of the frame. Yeah. So let's do a quick one.
Yeah, quick. We need a one-word suggestion from the audience.
Anyone. You? No.
Nothing?
All right.
Let's do a show about nothing.
All right, so let's say the person yells out broccoli, right?
Okay. See, you don't want that. You don't want food things.
Okay.
But that's what everybody does.
All right.
Nothing is.
Because everyone's standing around fucking hungry.
Yeah.
So that, I showed my IQ. I have an average IQ because I thought what everybody would.
Hey! Probably! It's green.
So what if somebody yells out a dildo? Can you do that? Is that anywhere? Was that too?
Well, usually someone will yell out, like, if somebody yells out something really loud and offensive.
That's offensive? A dildo?
Or something that's very suggestive, sexually suggestive, where it's like, you know.
Tranny cunt!
Yeah. It's a tranny cunt makes me think of peanut butter sandwiches.
So no food and no sex. Y'all
no, but really, no. Anybody, like, they do yell out whatever, but the thing is, if you get something like broccoli, you end up, or any food item, you end up taking it far away from that, so you're not just like, all right, we're eating some broccoli now.
Yeah.
I want a divorce.
What if someone yells out pillow? That's no good?
No.
I hump pillows.
I do.
Yeah. Well, that can come up in the scene. So say suggestions, pillows. You go, pillows make me think of humping them.
Yeah.
And then so that could be a scene or a scene.
So somebody else.
I'm just explaining improv.
No, 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 I understand.
We're not doing the thing.
I want to, but we don't have
to. Well, I have to.
What?
I dated my pillow. I took my pillow to prom. my pillow died in traffic when I was honking it. Mm-hmm. when I got in a car accident.
So then we jump into a scene, and so based off some of these crazy ideas we've done.
So this is all yours out of the hot tub. That's a good thing, right?
I ruined my pillow humping it in the hot tub.
Yeah, there you go.
I had
so
to do
hot
it.
Tub if I had a time machine.
I wish I had a time machine when Dad showed up.
Yeah.
What are you doing? You know what I'm doing, old man. Get out of my house.
See, then you want to act out the scene before you say all the good things that you would do in the scene.
You gotta build up to it.
You go and do it, but now it's like, okay, well now, if we start acting out the scene, like, are we going to do the things that we already just said? So it's just kind of like you're waiting, like the audience is waiting, like, oh, the dad's gonna walk in any minute now, like. Improv's not always good.
Improv 101. Nah. Well, listen, we tried. I'm not good at improv or playing stuff, it turns out.
Yeah. I'm looking at the paper. There's some cute bunnies. We got Easter coming up.
That's right.
Is this the one where Jesus comes back? Tragic loss.
I got offered a permanent position at my job today. It's good, but at the same time, like, it just seems like it's a further away goal from doing comedy. Because you need money to go to, you know, travel, do shows. So you need money. You have to get a job. Unless you're getting paid to do comedy, which is like, yeah, right. But then you feel stuck sometimes. Like, well, how do I...
Well, also, your job is at standard early morning hours? Like,
yeah, it's a day job, so like, I can
so
still...
So you always have the evenings.
Yes, yeah, but I'm saying, like,
and you can
there's
request,
no way... There's no
these off.
There's no way I'm going to have enough money to move to New York, but you can do it every day, but still, you feel stuck, you know, like, oh, man. But then, you know, I feel like if I at least had some time off, I could take some trips to New York during the week, you know, do maybe 2 days, and then...
So, I mean, you just talk to them about that, if that's what you want to do.
Well, I mean, I'll only bring it up to them, because my boss doesn't care.
Well, not even doing the... Well, don't mention as far as comedy,
even if it's comedy,
just your days off.
There's some holidays coming up, but it's like a 4th of July, they're open mics, they can't be good. I mean, I can't imagine. It's fucking hot, it's July, and you're in a basement, and it's like this.
Yeah. Hey, here's a movie. It's PG. It's rated PG. It's called God's Not Dead.
God's Not Dead.
Have you seen any previews on it?
I still haven't
it's
seen the Passion.
It's been out, right?
It's been out.
Yeah. I still haven't seen the Passion of
How
Christ.
How old
movie.
Is this newspaper?
This is today's Trentonian.
Now, what is a Trentonian?
Trentonian is just like
a
$1 in the Trenton, Jersey.
A Trent whore.
Yeah. It's a $1 publication. Pretty good. Here's one of the movies, Unsane, rated R.
So is that what we're doing now?
I like that. Unsane is a lady that's committed to a mental hospital, and they won't let her out. Really uncreative name. I went to go see the Melvins one time.
I don't know what that is.
The Melvins are a
band.
Yeah, they're a band.
I wasn't sure if it was
And the opening act was a band called Unsane. Mm. And I was like, wow, that name sucks. But you know what? They fucking kicked ass. They're a badass band.
They didn't live up to the name. The name didn't live up to them.
Yeah, that's right. They were insane, Unsane. They were.
Well, it's like there's a comedian out there named Talent. But they said he's funny. But when you hear the name Talent, you think this guy's a piece of shit. But then if he's actually funny, you're like, okay. Just like wrestlers name themselves stuff, you know, MVP and shit, you know. The wrestlers, they have gimmicks, you know.
The Strangers. Now, I love. Do you think that's just a bunch of people just sitting on their hands?
It's a movie about two guys that talk about that it's like, you know, the Stranger. Oh, and they bond over it, and then they talk about, like, it's like, what if you got the Stranger? And then it just turns out to be...
Well, that would be a loophole.
Two guys,
we wouldn't have to sit around all day on our hands. We could just jerk each other off.
But no, they still go through the process of numbing their hand before jerking a stranger.
Oh, because then it's not gay.
Now, Bill, you did that to the dentist recently, didn't you?
Oh, yeah, I went to the dentist, and they were sticking all these needles in my mouth, you see, to make my mouth all numb. I'm sure you know why. And I asked the lady.
So the doctor can throat fuck you while you're unconscious?
That's right. No, so I'm numb.
Yeah.
I'll be awake for the whole thing.
All right.
So I asked the lady, he's like, hey, can you stick some of those needles in my left hand, you know, for a stranger so I can go home and have like a 4-hour vacation? And she said yes, and she did. And I went home, and you know what happened? I found out I have a big fucking manly hand. It felt like I was getting reached around in jail.
That's...
What am I doing in jail with an erection?
Did you come harder?
No, it creeped me out. So then I just, you know, like,
it's like you're getting jerked off by an arm wrestler.
Yeah. I couldn't even play video games. It's just, I had to sit there with my retard hand. Just biting it.
He means special when he says retard.
I self-identify as retarded, so.
There you go.
I can say that.
Comment on the video.
Especially to parents of retarded children. I'm like, hey, buddy, I am retarded. Don't start that shit on me. I will kick your ass if you threaten me. I'm retarded. I don't know better.
We're up to 6 views right now. Come on.
Hey,
comment on this video.
It's like a pledge drive. You're talking in the middle of it to increase.
Okay. Yeah, fine. Audience members, run while you can.
I'll be your waiter. You gonna eat
anything? No, that's fine. Yeah. I don't know. I know he has to get something to drink, but it's like, yeah.
Hey, here's a movie. Did you hear of it? It's called Black Panther.
Will saw it.
Yeah.
Said it was overrated. Not because it was black, just because it was just...
It just wasn't good. It was just...
It wasn't?
Like crazy sci-fi, crazy land. It was...
Well, they made a lot of money, so whoever played the Black Panthers, nigga rich! I said the A word. And plus, look at this lineup, everybody. Yeah. When a racist looked like this... Yes.
I like how I waited until the audience member left before you said
that. Well, you had to bring it up.
You're within context. Is it anything like the movie Jumanji?
The new one with The Rock?
Oh, yeah. There is a scene where like a rhino charges and they're like, whoa, a rhino! And they run away from it. So yeah, it does have some parallels to Jumanji.
How about Tomb Raider?
Don't know that one. I last just played the old...
The new Tomb Raider?
Dig this.
Or the one with Angelina Jolie, which has got the big pouty lips.
I think this is an Angelina Jolie.
But no, they're making a new one.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
But this paper's hard to tell because it's also referring to movies that have been out like forever.
How about Sherlock Gnomes?
Oh. Is that a porno?
No, it's
that's
rated,
a midget porn.
It's rated NB for no boobs.
That's cool.
No, those are the movies I have to watch with my wife, you know.
So you go to like those local theaters, like those little...
The Dollar Theater?
Not at
all. Hey kids, remember the Dollar Theater?
The Nickelodeon?
Yeah, the Nickelodeon. Hey, Grandma! Hello!
Pussy power! We're still gonna... I'll still get a YouTube strike, even though it's in his voice. That's what happened. I played Pussy Power by Iggy Pop based on his suggestion.
Pussy Power.
And then YouTube gave me a strike.
Oh, yeah.
I know I played 20 seconds, like a minute of it.
Oh, yeah. You can't even do...
And it was not when it had 10,000 views.
10 seconds.
Yeah.
But the...
Let's all take a break here. That's
no,
right.
No, that's absolutely not.
I don't blame you.
Keep it going.
Let's talk about. Let me be racist and say like, hey, yeah. Josh, you look like you come from this family. This family suffered a tragic loss, and they look like they're they look
a tragic bad. Loss of obesity.
He overdosed on heroin.
So is this like a crazy? Are we in the dream? Like, are you the son that overdosed on heroin?
Yes.
And, like, this is your purgatory.
That's right. This is in Mercer County.
But yeah, you got the look going on, and you're like...
That's right. It looks like that comedian last night, Jabor. Look.
Yeah, Will Fowler.
Yeah.
He's a good kid. I support him.
Yeah.
Not just because he scares the shit out of me.
That's right. West Philly. Self-confessed killer gets reduced prison sentence. It's a black guy. You think it was a liberal judge?
This is a real, we're going back to the old days of newspapers. We're not going to go through
he's
our
like,
column.
He's like, ah, well, you didn't waste your time. Thanks for confessing.
Yeah.
Reduced sentence.
Now, this is interesting. 8 busted in Beverly City raid. 1 old white guy and a couple of black guys. Who says there's still racism in the world? This chick, I would jerk off to her. But see, the thing is, I can imagine getting a girl like this, because every girl I've ever got is
very
been fat.
You can have her. She's at the strip club.
Yeah.
Let's go. Stay.
That's the best. This is the 300th episode here.
I'm just going to eat a taco since this
300th episode.
300th episode here. Everyone's got one audience member left. Will Fitz is almost tapping out.
California regulators target web ads for illegal pot shops.
Just like when I do the JoshCast news, you know, like I don't prepare for my show. I read the news on the show, and I'm like, oh, wait, that doesn't make sense.
Bastards.
What do you guys think about girls playing sports? Still a joke?
I don't care about sports, so I don't care about girls playing sports.
This is brought to you by Taco Bell.
Miracle
Marijuana. This favorite snack of the JoshCast show. We do a podcast where we go to a bar, we get drunk, and then we go to a Taco Bell, and we eat tacos and we talk about a few things, and that's it. That's pretty cool.
It's just inspirational, I think, to anybody that thinks like, oh, I can't do a podcast, it's too much work.
Yeah.
Too much effort.
Oh, I mean, everyone, that's what everybody says, because everybody has a podcast. I just saw Howard Stern complains about it. Everyone's got a podcast.
Any asshole can do it. They didn't do it the hard way.
Yeah, but he does sound old the way he says it, because I get his point. Like, they don't have a name. But
fucking assholes.
But if there's 5,000 people doing a podcast, let's say in Philadelphia, there's not 5,000 radio stations.
You're some schmuck that fucking talks to himself on the radio. Not even on the radio.
Yeah.
I'm Howard Stern.
We sure showed him in his $1 billion.
I like Howard Stern.
I do too.
I haven't listened to him since he went to...
Yeah, a lot of people haven't. I downloaded a show from a certain website that's not welcome. But I have a VPN, so I can get child porn now. I don't watch it. But I just... that story about this is last night...
I don't watch it, but I can get it.
Last night I said that at the bar during a conversation, but nobody paid attention because everyone was busy talking, and I knew no one listened to me, so I was like, yeah, so I got a VPN so I could watch child porn. And not a single person looked at me. I just went back to their conversation.
I looked at you. I was like, what the fuck did you just say?
Cutting out coupons right now.
Shut the fuck up. Fucking leave me alone.
I'm not making fun of you.
Oh, good. Because I take offense.
You know Jim Florentine, he said when he was fuck. Jim Florentine, when he was broke, he used to chop out all the coupons and then even if it wasn't for his items, and he would just go to like some kid cashier who didn't give a fuck, and he would just give it to him, and the guy like, hey man, you didn't buy Bounty paper towels. He goes, yeah, just scan. And the kid would just scan, he would save like $27. That's fucking genius.
It's fucking genius.
I fucking love Florentine. Like so that doesn't make you poo all that sauce?
I mean, eventually I'll have to go. That's what happens.
Because I can't, like, when I go to California Tortilla, I can put maybe a drip of sauce on there. But remember that one time we were hanging out, you put ass in the tub?
Oh my god.
And then we went back to your house, me, you, and Tony Viejo, and you took like 3 dumps back to back. Your ass was literally in the tub.
Yeah. Yeah,
such a dead-on hot sauce name.
Well, that's also, I like that they rank and, like, number the sauces there, because now I know I don't go beyond a 6, that anything above a 6 is too much for me there.
I don't go anything above a 6 because I like fat girls.
Yeah.
They don't like me, though. So is this the bit you came up with, Bill? You decided to come on the newspaper? It's pretty genius. It's better that I don't have anything planned besides the oil tits thing.
It's okay.
And that didn't work.
How's my eating Taco Bell?
We all learned something.
That's good. I like how we're doing stuff on the show.
Yeah.
This is a show you can just hang.
Hey,
folks.
I heard, you know, I was going to sleep watching the Science Channel last night. And it wasn't the Science Channel. It was like, it doesn't matter. I was watching a thing on the universe. And they're talking about black holes.
Black holes, son.
Won't you come?
Now I'm gonna kill myself.
So, oh fuck. He did.
But Chester Bennington followed.
Mm-hmm.
Followed a year later. He didn't get enough attention, that guy. In the end, it doesn't even matter. Guess not. He had three kids and a wife. Had to take the easy way out.
So, anyway.
It's not really the easy way out.
The one of the science guys called a black hole.
Science!
God's dumpster.
God's butthole.
And I was just sitting, I was like, oh my god, God's dumpster. Yes.
Yep.
Yes. I was on acid. But, no, God's dumpster, that's a fucking great band name.
Doesn't sound.
I want a God's dumpster sticker.
Doesn't sound very scientific, though.
Let's recap.
No, it doesn't. But
so
I
oiled my body
out. God's dumpster, you know.
Bill Miller's cutting out coupons.
I'm taking the trash.
One audience member left and came back. And Lil Fitz is eating tacos. This is the JoshCast 300.
I would dig around in God's dumpster. I would pull things out of God's dumpster.
No, let's talk about Craigslist got rid of their personals.
Now you can't have sex in God's dumpster, thanks to Craigslist getting rid of their personals.
Now, here's the thing. They still have it on their website, but when you click on it, it gives you like not an FBI warning, but it took them like, what, 100 murders and rapes to finally say, yeah, I think people are, but it's mostly spam. Because when that Craigslist Killer movie came out, people got really scared to meet on Craigslist.
Yeah.
You know, like people used to actually meet off there and fuck quite a bit, believe it or not. And then when they found out people getting murdered, like, wait a minute, I can actually get killed? No, man. But girls are leaving their doors unlocked and having some random guy come in and just banging. Like, no guy would do that. No guy would just go, all right, I'm just going to lay here naked with my dick hard and the lady's going to jump on top of
me. Is that what that movie Craigslist Joe is about?
I didn't watch that. That's when he sells stuff, isn't it?
I don't know.
Craigslist Joe's about coffee. It's a guy who sold coffee on Craigslist. No, but just like Backpage, they claim they got rid of their personals, but they still have it. They say they got rid of the prostitutes, but if you go to Women Seeking Men, it's all prostitutes on there. That's why I prank call them.
Women don't seek men.
No, why would they seek men? But that's why I prank call them. But they're always so mean. Like if I was actually going to see a prostitute, I wouldn't see them because I'm like, you ask a question, you're like, hey, where are you located? Like, okay, sir, are you a cop? I'm like, no, I'm not a cop. Where are you located? Okay, you wasting my time. It's like, could you be a little nicer here?
Can you have sex with me?
Yeah.
Can I pay you? I mean,
you're running a business here. I mean, there's competition. There's girls in every section all over the city with their booty holes spread out, and it's like.
But you're upset about their phone customer service.
Yes. Okay. I wish you could write Yelp reviews about it, like anything else, like. Yeah, Shaquita, this black hooker I went to, really nice girl, really good head game, but terrible on the phone. I think
hello, Josh!
Bill was playing the role of Shaquita here.
How are you? Congratulations on your 300th episode, Josh!
Thank you. Thank you, cover girl.
I saw you with your shirt off.
Oh, what did you think about that?
It made me wet!
No way. Wet as in sweaty wet?
Yeah.
Oh, what an episode. You guys really surprised me.
It was a fallacy.
I'm going to put sensors on my nipples.
Okay.
Like Doritos or something. Nobody needs to see that. I really do have pepperoni nipples, though.
Can you put dicks on mine?
I mean, I would if YouTube would have taken them. Now someone's going to report me. I have enough strikes already.
Bullshit.
Yeah, that's the thing. YouTube steals everything.
Can they be cartoon dicks?
I think that's still kind of illegal. It's all about getting reported. As long as someone has.
Well, how about just balls?
That too.
That too, he says.
So,
I feel like I'm like in a car ride with my
father. So how many tacos have you had tonight? That's the fourth taco?
Well, how many did you have?
I had two, and I had a pack of cinnamon.
Give me one of those motherfuckers.
Yeah, now Bill's gonna eat a taco.
Alright. Is there bean in it?
Taco Tico.
Beef, cheese, and lettuce, and then there's hot sauces.
They're all beef, cheese, and lettuce. That's all you can get at Taco Bell.
It certainly is.
They won't make me a soft chicken taco. We talked about this, even though they have soft tacos.
Are you telling me hot isn't the hottest?
Hot isn't the hottest.
Weird.
Fire isn't the hottest.
No, Diablo, the devil.
Diablo is...
It's only the fun Spanish devil.
Diablo is a Spanish for
burning butthole. Right?
No entiendo.
Now, if I'm going to eat Taco Bell, I'm not going to eat it hot.
It's never hot. You're lucky if you get
it.
If
I can smell the bag, the heat and stink coming off the bag, I'm not going to eat it. But I'll eat it cold right out of the fridge.
That's the best way to eat it.
After, like,
it's shitty takeout food. It's supposed to be.
Yeah, oh, I love cold Chinese food, yeah.
Yeah, I eat cold Chinese food.
Congealed lo mein.
And my mom and my mom says, heat it up. And I go, shut up, cunt, who paid for it?
Oh,
that's nice. See, I mean, that's the only thing I said tonight to make your audience member laugh.
We did it, folks.
It was a genuine laugh.
All right.
Stop the shit out of me.
And you didn't even have to do it in like a...
And I had to cheat and say the C word.
You didn't do it in like a dice voice, too, to show that you're insincere about it or that it's a bit. It's just your
mind. No, you meant that.
No, I didn't.
That's sincere.
It was sincere.
You're terrible to your mother. Happy Easter.
What does Easter have to do with mothers? Mother's
Whenever I curse at the Easter dinner table, someone tells me, Bill, be quiet. It's Easter. And I'm like, fuck you!
Scott Terry, Jon Rice were supposed to be on the show tonight. They didn't show up. Fuck you guys! Jon Rice, I know he's getting laid in Jersey, so I understand. Good for you. Let's call Jon Rice right now. I usually call people on the show, they never pick up. He's gonna go soft right now, right in his girlfriend. Like, oh fuck, man. Who's calling me?
Going soft in the girlfriend.
Nah, actually, I'm the only person
I've Great band name!
No. Let's Great see. Album name. He might be it's like a third album, going soft on the girlfriend.
He might be actually in the car right now. I mean, he might actually be at the bar right now and badmouth him. You know, he wakes up late.
Mm-hmm. Hydroxy cut, $5 right. off.
I'm going to get the voicemail. Hey, John. This is Josh Jackaboo. I'm here with Will Fitz and Bill Miller. And you're on the JoshCast 300.
Hey.
I decided to bother you since you didn't want to come out tonight. I don't blame you. Where you at, Jersey?
Yeah.
All right. It's not a bad time, is it?
Sure.
I'll go closer. Oh, well, so far in the show, it's good that you weren't here. I took my shirt off and put baby oil over my body for the special episode. Will Fitz is eating tacos. Bill Miller's now eating tacos. Bill Miller brought newspapers.
Clipping coupons.
So it's been a pretty interesting night so far. Oh yeah, Will Fitz brought a whole pack, man. It would have been great if you were here. Man, some drinks, had some tacos, a whole box. Yeah.
Thank you, Will.
Yeah, that's right.
Sorry I made fun of you.
He brought
Twist
as well. Those fucking, I don't know what they are.
Everyone
Tell your father I said hi.
Send a twist.
That was a good one. Sally, Jesse, Raphael.
So, John, what's the plan tonight? Just to hang out with your chick?
Yeah, it's nice out, so I figured, hang out here.
Now, you're in Jersey a lot. You might as well move there, right? Racist Johnny from Jersey? I think you have to pay to leave every time. But you can leave and become a taproom comic.
I don't know. I don't know if I can handle that. I'm over at Northeast Comedy Cabaret.
Yeah!
Let's build a Trenton scene.
No.
Yeah, why not? There's a lot of gigs in Trenton that we can form. What do you think about building a Trenton scene, John?
A what?
A Trenton scene, a comedy scene. Like the one we have in the Northeast, but in Trenton.
They probably
have
one. It's
probably
weird.
They have one already.
What? No, they don't.
A Northeast Trenton, don't they?
No, they don't.
They have something.
Otherwise, Bill Miller wouldn't be here. He'd be in Trenton.
Yeah. Hey, John, I just want to thank you for, well, thank you. You know why.
For your service.
Because I love you. Thank you.
And so,
thank you for all the gifts you bring everybody, John. Not just your comedy. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, you're soft on the eyes, and I appreciate it. Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you. I bring happiness to
You are very good at that. You make a little profit off that.
Good.
Must be nice.
John, sounds like a good time. It sounds like you're having a better time there. all right.
Well, John, thanks for being on the show, man. I didn't know I had to call you. I don't blame you, but thanks, man, for picking up. Yeah, most people put it to voicemail when I call, so I appreciate you picking up. Oh, fuck, so you picked up by accident. That sucks.
No, I didn't.
All right, well, Jon Rice, everybody. Thank you, John. Hope to see you next week. See you, buddy. God bless you.
See you, guys.
See you, buddy.
Good night.
All right.
JoshCast
300. He was still talking. I hung up.
So here's something I noticed. I have this coupon for Dawn dishwashing soap detergent. It has. I noticed that they have a blue Dawn. They have a green Dawn. They have a purple Dawn.
That's for black people.
And they have an orange Dawn.
That's for Irish people.
But they don't have a red Dawn.
I think they do.
No, they do not.
I've seen red detergent.
They may have a light pink Dawn, but it is.
I saw a grapefruit Dawn. I think it was red.
They don't have like cool extreme names like
communist.
Neon
electric commie.
Dawn.
Neon electric.
So
culturalized socialist.
I never like to get personal. How's the day life going?
It's militant socialist.
No, it's not going on. But you don't look really anymore much, right?
No.
You're a MGTOW like me.
What the hell's that?
Man go on his own way.
Oh. That's a red pill philosophy about.
Yeah.
About determining your.
I gotta teach you.
Evaluating your fucking life when it comes to getting involved with women.
What?
Yeah, so MGTOW, I think I told you about it before. It's men go on their own way. It's guys who are angry and bitter with women. So they decide to not approach them, not deal with them, not pursue sex, and they just focus on other things. Like, you know, their hobbies, their passions, and, you know, never get married. Like, they'll have casual sex if they could, but don't get married, don't get a relationship, don't. So you sound like a MGTOW. You don't seem into it anymore.
No.
I mean, I know you would like a girlfriend, but you don't seem, you don't have the time, you have energy, right?
No, it's not that I don't have the time. The energy, maybe. But, yeah.
I know you don't talk about it, but, like, you told me, well, I don't know, if this is personally, you're trying to get back into, maybe try some apps, some dating apps?
But it's also, again, the energy to...
You gotta swipe.
Exhausting.
And, like, that could take all day, because, like, then some guys, what they do is they pay for extra money, and they swipe more. So, like, Tinder will give you, like, was it 50 swipes or 100 swipes, and then if you want more, you got to pay, like maybe $2-3, and then you can swipe another 100 times. It's just a lot of work.
Women really want your bed to look nice in order to have sex with them in it. Like, and I don't spend a lot of money in the bedroom, you know. I have a coupon here for moving blankets. You know, it's only $6 for moving blankets.
Harbor Freight.
Why get real ones when you can get like some fucking moving? I mean, you've slept in a U-Haul before, haven't you? Going across, moving some blankets.
On the next JoshCast episode, I'm going to take pictures of Will Fitz for his dating profile. We're going to start tonight because he's got a suit on. How goodly you look, man. You look like you have a job, like I say. You dress for him. So take some pictures, get you on there.
I'm already on the internet and with the views this has. Oh,
come on. Last episode had, like I said, 8 views, I think. Probably 2 from me, 2 from Bill, and 3 or 4 other people who might have watched it for 2 seconds and said, meow, meow. Maybe Darin.
They said meow meow, which is MGTOW.
MGTOW.
MGTOW. MGTOW.
MGTOW.
Yeah.
So what do you think about that, Will?
I don't like the acronym. I think, you know, it just sounds like what we call the curmudgeon. Just like, I'm an angry old man. Leave me alone to my lapidoptery and stuff.
And my little pony. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I tried to take you out to a salsa night once, twice.
Oh, and yeah, no.
It wasn't that bad. It was just, I feel like you didn't give it a chance, but I don't, I mean, the girls just want to dance there, you know? They're not want to meet anybody. I mean, they want to meet guys, but they don't want to, like, unless, you know, you're a tall guy or some shit. Well, Jon Rice, actually, first night I brought Jon Rice to a salsa night, a chick approached him. He didn't dance, which is weird, so he was kind of awkward just dancing.
Let's talk about salsas making me
laugh. Yeah! Will's trying to give himself diarrhea because he needs a girlfriend. If you had a girlfriend, she'd be like, "Stop! That's your fourth one." That's what you need in your life, right?
I'd say, woman.
You don't know my metabolism.
Yeah, see, he's a mixer. No, so Jon Rice got approached by this chick, and he was dating
Taco
her.
Taco Bell really gets my metabolism fucking
chill. Jon Rice met his girlfriend because of me, because
metabolizes right out of my ass.
I took Jon Rice to a salsa night. He got approached by this girl. He started dating her. Then he went to a concert with that girl. They got into an argument. He met his current girlfriend at that concert, all because of me. Now, I don't take credit for all of it, but I'm saying it would have happened if I didn't take him to that salsa night. So you're welcome, John.
He's an ex. We're always getting sick.
Yeah.
Do you feel TJ Miller does the Mucinex commercials, I think.
You can use those as self-checkout, can't you?
Self-checkout? Yeah, they got the barcode.
I see people do that.
But, oh my god, if it's like expired, forget it.
When I see a person doing that, usually I go, take your time, Nick and Poop.
They got someone at the cigarette counter. That's where I go.
Oh, at CVS, you mean?
No, at like the grocery store. Mm-hmm. I don't fuck with that machine thing. Fuck that.
What, self-checkout?
Yeah, they're not going to accept my bullshit coupon.
I got my penis stuck in one of those one time.
Why?
I don't know. Like it was
you
out.
You know why?
It was out.
It's like, this will be funny.
My little nub. It was out, and I went to put my credit card in. Next thing you know, I'm like, and everyone's like, come on, buddy, three items at a time. Nobody cared my dick was about to rip off. All they cared about was their precious time.
That's what we in the comedy business call a false premise. It didn't really happen.
Yes, it did. I can make up whatever I want. It's my show.
I know what a false premise is, you bastard.
You think you're a Dane Cook?
No, Dane Cook, all true stories. He really got hit by a car. He really cheated on his girlfriend. He really got into an argument with a guy at Burger King. Dane Cook is the real deal.
But the guy at Burger King was like, but you're Dane Cook.
Yeah. The comedians hate Dane Cook. I thought he was good. We all.
I like him. I mean, when I was a little kid and I was first introduced to Dane Cook, I was rolling on motherfucking
floor. Yeah, because as kids, we love him. As you get older, it's like, yeah, but...
You get used to it.
He had millions of 18-year-old fans on MySpace. Sold a million comedy albums.
I still laugh at the coats thing. Someone took a shit on my coat.
You should do... You know what you should do next week? You should do...
It wasn't my coat.
You should do the Dane Cook type of style when you're just acting out everything, and then at the very last minute, you guys know what I was doing? Bill Cosby. Try it.
I don't know.
I'll forget
it. Okay, I will.
No, don't try it. See, that's my first psychology. When I told him not to try it, then he wants to do it. But when I said try it, he says no. See, that's how you get this guy. You gotta do the opposite.
I would say do it. Just come off doing Dane Cook's material, and then at the end, just, you know, say this was in honor of Dane. We'll miss you, big guy.
What if I do Dane?
Make everyone check their phones real quick. It's dead.
What if I do Dane Cook's material in Stephen Wright's delivery? That's gonna work.
Yeah, that sounds great.
I hope no one took a shit on
you were just about to cut that lady.
I hope no one took a shit on my coat. There's no interrupting me.
Now,
get into the
look at this. Look at that. There you go, Josh.
You cut her cunt.
Look at that. Yeah. She's ready for you, Josh.
You cut her cunt.
You can go your own way.
You're a cunt cutter.
She went like this to, oh, 300 episode. Hooray. Whoa. 299 episode. 300th episode.
Whoa.
301 episode.
Whoa. Is this your favorite bar in Northeast? This is the only bar in Northeast I go to. I mean, what about you? You go to the bars in the area? And you say you like the bartender area because he sexually flirts with you, didn't you say?
No.
No, he doesn't. He doesn't.
He's a nice guy. And
no, he is, but that's being bad.
Takes care of me with the drinks.
He does. Stuff. I didn't say he didn't.
Yeah. But no,
this isn't fucking charity. We like coming here.
No, I didn't say we did. I is a great bartender.
That's right.
Plus, there's I don't like people that much, and there's not a lot of people here, so.
Pretty good.
I thought you were a people guy. That's why you have so many animals.
Under your porch. In your garden. Buried.
It's falling flat. That's falling flat. I apologize.
You could have been out there. You're having a good time. Instead, you're in here. Listen, this didn't go as well as the last episode. What did we do different in the last episode? Was it better? Did you think the last episode went better?
There's a weird balance of there's trying too hard and not trying
anything at all.
We didn't find that balance. We tried both ends of the spectrum and
I die for mediocrity.
Well, it's not my fault. You guys are here too.
I haven't listened to the other 299 episodes.
Oh, no, they're not any better.
It's Ace's...
I didn't say that.
Can we find the first?
Well, here's the problem. The first one, I put on this website called DipShare, the first six or seven, and the website just died. I guess the guy didn't pay his bills to own it or some shit, so I don't have the first six or seven. But the first episode, I played a clip of my dad yelling. My dad takes a shower with the door open, and he yells at my mom. Like, he goes on rants. Like, you fucking bitch, I can't do any fucking does. And he talks like a Puerto Rican guy. That's my Polish dad. And I recorded him for 6 minutes. And I played some stuff. And people told me they liked it. And, yeah, that was the first episode. And that was back in the MySpace days.
Bring your father here.
I would. But anyway, I gotta drive my mom to work. And then,
we'll do the podcast in your father's vehicle.
I would like to do that. But like I said, my parents, they tell me all the time how funny I am, and that's why I bring my camera here. And
that's why you still do it.
That's why. It's like, I don't want to stop because of them. It's like, I know I'm funny.
Yeah, fuck them. You know. No, you're funny. You're a funny guy.
Yeah.
Fucking fuck.
I'm funny here.
Oh, you're fucking
that
you're
means
fucking
something.
You're a funny guy. Fuck them.
Thanks, man. But yeah, I mean, it's like, you know. Supportive parents, they didn't want me to go to college, and only parents that didn't want, because they didn't want to pay for it. They're like, you ain't go to college, but we ain't gonna help you pay for it.
Yeah.
We're about to play the lottery. It's like most people, parents save for their kids. You know, parent college fund when they're born. Not everybody, but some do.
Why did you pull out?
I did. My mom told me I was supposed to be a miscarriage. That's it. That's a joke I do with my act. Here's the bit. So I had a brother that was born before me. There was a miscarriage. You clap if you want. He was probably an asshole. Yeah, I know that.
Did she name him?
No. Yeah, she did. His name was
she
Jason.
Did.
Supposed
they,
to be Jason.
She must be Catholic.
Yeah. So, well, so sure, she had a miscarriage. So, she asked me to lend her money for lottery. And I said, I'm not letting you. She broke into my room or whatever. It doesn't matter. And she's like, the wrong son died. Meaning I should have been the miscarriage.
She was banking on miscarriage. She was going to Six Flags.
Also, yeah, I think you're just twisting the script. This is Stand By Me. This is the old Stephen King movie.
No, it's really
it's like, it should have been you, Gord.
No.
And it's a crazy dream. And then you wake up and you lose.
Not all
right. Loses his comb.
That's a real thing she said to me. I'm supposed to be a fucking miscarriage. He goes, no, I'm sorry. The wrong son died. No, I didn't mean to say that. Well, yeah, that's the kind of parents I have.
Yeah. Now you get up here and tell stories like Lardass.
Yeah.
That's your escape. That's your that Stephen King. All right.
That's what's the
Stand By Me.
No, what's the guy's
name? No, wait. Lean On Me.
Stand By Me.
Stand By Me.
Lean On Me is a song in the movie. Lean On.
It's
no,
not
no.
In the movie.
That's a different movie.
Yes, it is.
That's
Lean On Me is not in Stand By Me.
Oh,
no, it's not.
Was it a song?
It is a song, but it's not in Stand By Me.
I haven't seen that movie.
Is Lean On Me played in Lean On Me? Because that would make sense.
Yeah. We do it all night.
Morgan Freeman.
It has all of
that
the...
I'm going to watch that movie when I go home.
Stand By Me's soundtrack is entirely puns and play on words. It also has Friend Like Me, the song from Aladdin, of the dead kid that they're looking for wakes up and starts singing that to the little kids when they find his body. He sings the Robin Williams... Genie song.
Oh, when they find Robin Williams' like dead body.
Yeah, they find Stand By Me.
Like with the belt.
In case you haven't seen it, yeah, the kids go walking down the train track to search for Robin Williams' dead body.
Okay, so oh my God, so here's a great topic.
Now be careful, we're trying too hard here.
What song do you play in the room on like repeat for people to find your dead body to? Because it's like, I'm not a note guy. I'm not going to write a note, but I'll just like leave a song on repeat. And then they come out and they're like, oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, what is this? Oh, it's Bill.
It seems too stereotypical. If I was filming the scene, I know it'd be Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata.
Oh, wow.
Just that play as the person walks in the room, turns around stuff, and then like, you know, as it reaches like a high point in the song, the records skip it because of course it has to be on a record player.
I could. It'd be so funny if you like wore the suit and then like painted your face like you're dead. Like paint it green. Even though you're actually gonna kill yourself. But it's like, you know, I want it to seem like I've been here.
Been,
like,
been here a while, like, because I know my neighbors will come right away from the gunshot, but then they'll be like, this doesn't make any sense. I just heard the shot like 3 minutes ago.
Yeah.
And the song's still.
Yeah, yeah. 3D effects makeup. What the fuck's going on here? Are you dead?
Let's call a live podcast show and see if they care about the JoshCast 300. No, I'm kidding. I'm not going to call them because they hate me. Which I'm glad because we used to do a show before that.
Josh didn't want to tell us his song because he wants it to be a surprise.
I don't have a
classic.
Pussy Power. That's what I want to do.
Really fucking Pussy Power. Pussy Power.
That kind of sounds like Beavis and Butthead would do like that. Mike Judge.
I love Mike Judge. That was the best part of
Beavis
and Butthead.
Try hard. Suit's trying hard. Even though you look good.
Fucking suit.
I'm making fun of a guy in a suit.
Whenever I do a thumbs up.
Keep dressing up, pal.
Whenever I do a thumbs up, it's because I'm nervous. Like, I don't know what else to do.
Well, you know, don't try so hard. That's all we're doing.
Whenever someone catches me at work, I'm like.
you know, just stand there, giving like the little okay thing. You're like, yeah. Oh, that's all, bitch.
Did you, are you still applying for his job?
Oh, I'm going to wait until I get my all my insurance stuff through.
Okay.
Like, I'm fixing my teeth. I want to be able to get all my teeth fixed before I can jump ship.
Before you carry dead bodies.
Yeah. I totally do that. I'm not ashamed.
No, it's a good job.
Also, you didn't answer your songs.
I'm such a hipster douche, no one's going to know it. I'm going to say it, and Josh is going to be like, who's that? Who cares?
No, I didn't say who cares.
Melvins. I don't know what that is.
I thought Melvins was like a play.
Yeah, I went to go see the Melvins, and that does sound
yeah,
good.
The Melvins.
You're good. It would be like a song by this artist called Kramer, and it's called, the title track is...
Yeah. Yeah. Slide
it. He's dead. That's how I'll kill myself. I'll walk into a room, and then stab myself.
Do the bit he did at the Laugh Factory.
Anyway, it would be it's the song's called Next Time Try Compassion.
Okay.
Yeah. That's, you know what? The title. It's really, it's just ambient, like just fucking really like just fucking wailing fucking music with no words. But you'd see the title track and you'd be like, oh fuck.
But hearing the bit that you did, just the sound, I thought you were about to do Baker Street, Jerry Rafferty. And I'm just like, oh.
Bleeding Gums Murphy.
That's it.
Bleeding Gums Murphy.
That's right.
That was his song.
That's right.
Lisa played when he died.
And, fucking, that's the kind of song that, like, if you're gonna kill yourself to it, it's gonna be in a fucking white convertible and you're gonna drive off a bridge. You know?
Well, also going with, iconic saxophone songs to kill yourself to. Careless Whispers.
Careless Whispers. I don't know that one.
The George Michael one, and the sexy saxophone guy plays it. You hire the sexy sax man to come play.
Right, the denim vest.
Leather vest, leather pants. Sergio, the sexy sax man.
Yes.
So somebody comes in, they're thinking, ooh, it's going to be a nice night. And you have rose petals scattered, and then there you are with an empty bottle of pills. Like,
oh, fuck. There used to be this website called Suicide Shirts, and they would just be different depictions of suicides. Like, there would be a guy with his head in the oven. There would be another one where a guy's hanging out in his car, and there's a pipe that goes all the way from the exhaust into the window. There's one of the guy falling off a building. There's one where it's like he's in a chair just like this, and he has a shotgun in his mouth, and he's just trying to get that toe in.
Did the money for the shirts go to pay for suicide prevention, or was
no? It went to a cool dude.
It's just a dude with a dick who's like, just yeah, this is fucking.
There, I was gonna get the samurai one where it's like. Yeah, and there's like incense burning. It's fucking great. Don't make fun of the Japanese.
Don't call them Japs. That's a reason.
Don't make fun of Japanese suicide because they take honor in it.
That's true. That's why they bow and stab themselves.
That's right. It's very. Ooh. Oh, I shamed my family. This is the only thing I could do to fucking make my family's name better. Is to control alt. Delete.
They're dead. Like, you know, they can't come after you or whatever. They just you find one like that. I go to one of them panty vending machines and
it's penny.
Yeah, put them over the head though. Make them look like a little papusai hentai pervert with the panties on the head and the sword in their gut.
Oh yeah, with his anime pillow.
face. Stage that in the corner like you walk in.
Oh my god, I love
that,
it.
I love that on
the
shirt.
I love it, yeah. But you know what? The website's gone. Like, because it's like when I found it, it was 2002, and I'm like, my folks won't let me buy a shirt with a credit card. You know, and now it's like, okay, now I've fucking got a fucking debit card. I can buy things online. Let's go to suicideshirts.com. Fucking gone.
Now you're just stuck having to buy a shitty t-shirt, hell shirt, like all the other a-holes.
Yeah, fuck that shit.
Now, Bill, last night you were talking, you said that.
I bombed last night.
No.
This was... This is material. It was material in its infancy.
No, he means at the bar, not your.
Wait a minute. Hey, you idiot.
No, I'm sorry.
No, I'm kidding. No, you're saying you feel like you kill out in the bar.
Oh, yeah, I nail it in the bar.
But then, you know, you're up here, you're feeling it. Why is that? You think when you're up here, you.
I just don't think I've found my voice yet.
Yeah, well, that takes a long time. Yeah. I mean, but at the bar.
I'm real jocular, and people fuck.
But at the bar, you found your voice. You said you kill out there, so I mean,
it's weird.
So why don't you pretend that everybody's out in the bar next time you're on stage?
I don't know. Maybe it's because of the noise. I don't know.
So tell me to make some noise. Go.
Make
some noise.
What if they're sabotaging you out there? I'm like, it's really good. You should.
No, I wouldn't.
Instead, you'd be like, you fuck.
I try not to. No, I don't get like, no. I don't bring up fucking. But it's different out there because out there, I'm not on stage. And I'm fucking, you know, I'm cutting it with the lady at the grocery store, you know, like fucking that's.
Cutting farts?
I'm always fucking on.
On something. Mushrooms, acid. Hey.
But I'm not always on stage. See?
I heard a guy talking about stand up on the radio. He's like, it's so easy. Just talk to people like you talk to your friends. But what if your friends aren't, what if you're not interested and your friends aren't interested?
Well, it depends too. Like, sometimes you're asking for a dialogue or like asking, leaving open ended questions with the audience can be a mistake too. Where it's, you know, when you're like watching the Melvins perform and stuff. And
I would never
like,
say that.
No,
No, but I was doing a whole room of hipster douches.
But that's what I mean. Like, if say you had a few friends that were hipster douches that laughed at that, and then you see this room is obviously not hipster douches.
Never.
You don't just talk about
you
it. You
can't
like
talk
that.
About it
yeah.
like that.
So you gotta be like, you know, when you're in your Northeast home and you know you're watching the Eagles on the TV, and then a black guy comes up and rings the doorbell, and you're like, you mute it real quick.
Are you doing Chris Farley right now?
JoJo, he's your circus boy.
but it's like you can't win either way. You can't act like your friends are here when that's not the audience. You can't just guess and pander to, you know, everybody says that the Northeast audience is just racist white
people. I try to do things that relate to people. Like last night I talked about taking a shower with your father.
That was good.
And
how orphans don't do that. They don't have that opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Well, that worked because that's also playing off of the
orphan.
The previous comedian brought up orphan, so it also shows it's a callback to somebody.
Well, Bill was the first guy.
I was the first guy. And then he was like, oh, dude, the orphan bit.
Well, Ed McGonagall was first. Oh, he was
the
first
up the crowd.
Yeah, but he was the first guy on the list.
Okay, I'm remembering the Tarantino style.
Yeah, like, there you go.
Order and, I assumed you came after Scott talked about being an orphan.
So. No, it's okay. Mm-hmm. It's okay. It's okay.
It's okay. We bombed for an hour.
No.
But
no.
I appreciate the effort.
It was just me.
It was me. It was a lot of times. Should we wrap this thing up?
I don't remember. We didn't start exactly at 8.
We started at 8:30, but you know, that's kind of a good thing because, you know, get some drinks, get some food, hang out.
Again, brought to you by Taco Bell.
Taco Bell?
Not at all. Not in the least. No sponsorship.
Well, listen, we don't have a strong end, and maybe I should have saved the baby oil thing for the end. Maybe that would have been better.
You really threw the baby oil with the bathwater.
I did, but you know what? That was the only idea I had that plan for a week, and I didn't expect it to kill, but I knew it would just add something.
There's no coupons, to tell you that.
It wasn't, but I thank you guys for coming out to help me do this show. You know, my podcast, I do it by myself in front of my home computer, like everything else.
We won a trophy, an award.
And I complain. I go, nobody wants to fucking help me do my show. Nobody wants to. Oh, he's got fiery gas.
No, I thought it did.
And, you know, Bill,
just poop.
Ever since I've been hanging out.
Just shit my pants.
Ever since I, you know, known Bill, I mean, he's been on JoshCast, and he was part of True Life Not Doritos. Now he's, you know, he's been helping me, and every once in a while you would do it too, and I don't blame you for it, you know, because you're busy. But I appreciate you guys doing it, because, you know, people don't want to be associated with me. I get why.
This is the sad part of the podcast.
Well, it is because, you know.
Credits rolling.
I feel like I'm misunderstood, and I feel like people, they take everything I say so seriously. I'm just trying to be funny. You know, I saw that guy from Night of the Living Dead. You remember that guy? The blonde hair guy? He bit his girlfriend? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
He was like, oh,
my God, they're coming to get you, Barbara.
No, that's not the beginning. Alright, whatever. Well, anyways, I hate to get all mushy, right? I'm a mushy looking fuck. But I'm just saying that, you know, people don't want to be associated with me because, you know, the act I do. I do a dirty act, you know. I drop the C word. I drop the N word. I talk about pussies and cocks and it all. It's true. But, you know, I appreciate you guys coming out. And I appreciated one audience member for coming out. That was very nice. And I knew he would be disappointed, but I didn't want to say none at the bar because I was too embarrassed to say, you want to check this out? But he's been to many open mics where it's just like this. And listen, we try our best here at our little Northeast Cabaret. So let's all stand up. All
right.
Stand up for JoshCast. This is JoshCast 300. I can't promise you the show will get better. It probably won't. But...
Yeah,
every other week.
Another 300 episodes.
Here's to another 100. This is the longest podcast in Philly. Once again, I'm a quantity guy, not a quality guy. I brag about the amount I've been doing.
Dropping loads.
Just like my set list, I've been on stage 500 or something times. That's not a lot. I only average once or twice a week, but, you know. Anyways, Bill Miller, Will Fitz, Josh Jack, one audience member, Jon Rice, thanks for, I wouldn't say calling it, I called him.
Scott Terry, he was on last night, so audio. But, yeah. So anyways, thank you. Have you listened to all 3 hours of this? Wow!
Holy cow!
You got too much time on your hands.
You get a burrito.
That's
send us an email. We'll mail
now, guys, let's take our weekies out. I will save that for the 400. Thank you for watching and listening!